Ladies and gentlemen, welcome again once more to Blades Against Band with Lankhmar. Thank you so much for tuning in. For you guys at home watching on the Twitch stream, thank you all for showing up. And if you're catching us for the first time on YouTube, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell button, and we'll fill you up your inbox with all kinds of wonderful stuff that we'll be doing from week to week, because we're constantly doing new and great stuff. So Blades Against Bandwidth, this is an ongoing campaign where I am running this group of worthies through the published DCC Lankhmar adventures. And tonight is night three of our sojourn into Masks of Lankhmar. We got a special guest tonight. I hope everyone recognizes, ladies and gentlemen, is Elder Jim Skatch. Welcome!
Special is
no one applaud for him. Correct. No cheers.
No.
He gets
boo. I will.
Boo.
Thank you, Jeff. Thank you.
Thanks, Tim.
So Mr. Skatch, what do you got going on these days? What are you working on? This is your free plug hour. This time for it.
Oh boy. Actually nothing. I got a new job and that's been sucking
that's
up all
true.
Of my
you
time.
Woo!
I did send around to a couple of people whose opinion I think may be okay. Some work I might do for the Gong Farmers. A way to do thieves a little more customized. And actually I've been asked to write something about something I said at, what was the last one we were at?
I don't know. He was preaching his ideas.
When I was preaching at,
at the social forum.
At the cultural exchange. Sure. Yeah. So mostly that stuff.
That is all good stuff. And, I recommend the, Gong Farmer's Almanac highly. And I certainly recommend, checking out the, anything Skatch writes for it. Cause God knows.
That's a good plug. If you guys don't know, I'm going to be one of the administrators for Gong Farmers this year. And one thing that I'm really trying to push, and Haley's one of them, even though she cannot be considered a kid anymore, is I'm putting together a DCC kids issue. So if you were a kid that grew up playing DCC or a current kid playing DCC, I would like to put together a all Winterkind DCC issue. So if you look up the Gong Farmers email address, website, I think it's just Gong Farmers at WordPress, do a Google search. There'll be stuff on there to submit things. So please.
By all means, Generation Gong Farmer, we're talking to you. What's up, kitty? Hello. My cats would be losing their brains.
I cannot imagine a cat being that calm in that situation.
No, I cannot either. Hey, speaking of situations, let's talk about the situation we find ourselves in at the beginning of tonight's adventure. So we have ventured into the old temple, the tenement and spire of Djil. So the temple of Djil, where the masks that we are searching for are rumored to be hidden. We know it is somewhere within this compound, and we arrived here last time. We found out that we had been being tailed by the Thieves Guild of Lankhmar, and that guy got dealt with pretty good. He was our first, but I got a feeling not our last hostage. So let's keep an eye out for if you're keeping hostage count back home. We're up to one, so congratulations. And at this point, we faced the local toughs, the Spider Gang, and we only allowed their wizard to live with the his promise that he would teach Ka'a some of his unique spider magic, which is something that's happening, and Jeff and I have been working on the downtime, and it's going to be awesome. So, which is all going to be very, very cool. And now, the six of y'all find yourselves outside of the actual spire, the entrance to the highest point in the entire temple compound. So at one point, this compound was must have been this incredible, beautiful place. The priestess of the Mystery of Djil had been chased out some 100 years ago, and now the entire place has been turned into a kind of a shanty town with just squatters everywhere you look, who have built up these little clapboard tenements and houses and huts there within the interior. But right now, we find ourselves out here in front of the entrance of the spire. A massive pillar stands in the far end of the former temple, rising from floor to soaring ceiling. Measuring roughly 60-foot square, the stone support is defaced by grime, soot, and inscribed graffiti left by generations of slum dwellers. Faintly visible beneath the obscuring dirt and are bas-relief head located 10 feet up the pillar. So on all four sides of it, you can see each side has got a bas-relief figure.
Different carvings or the same?
They are different carvings. You take a look at them, walking around, you see that they are a goblet, a length of chain links, a horned crescent moon, and a skull wearing a domino-style mask.
Oh, what was that poem?
Yeah, it reminds me of that poem.
We go back to the poem, which was translated for us.
I have it. Beneath neither cup nor chain nor moon do I stand, but under the gaze of visage, face secret and awaiting the touch of the hand, is where our resting place is to be found, safe from thief, heretic, or sniffling hound. So I guess we need to go through the skull, by the skull.
Oh, yeah.
Is that the plan?
You said that's on the column, Brendan, or is there a doorway?
On the column. You don't see any doorway in the actual column itself.
I'll stand underneath the skull and look up at it.
Yeah, from underneath, I mean, it definitely seems to fit in with the poem.
I touch it with my hand.
Okay, you touch it with your, like the, well, the skull is like 10 feet up, so you'd have to get up on something to actually touch the skull.
I'll give him a boost.
Wait, is there anything on the wall below it that, like, looks like a hand or something?
All right, Lucarch, you're gonna kind of feel around there and check, or what the...
Yeah, you want me to feel? Okay, yeah, sure. I'm a thief. I don't touch nothing. Wait, did I say that out loud?
Honestly, I thought you were just an average guy.
I'm just an average cat.
Average guy. Well, yeah, I'll tell you what. Let me see if I can look.
Find it.
Why don't you give me a intelligence check?
Oh. Poor. Five.
Yeah.
Four. Four.
You don't instantly, without touching it, you don't instantly find anything. You take a careful look, and I mean, problem is that this isn't like, you know, fresh wall. I mean, literally, like, there's a giant mural in the middle of it that says, spiders rule, and there's 8,000 smaller things. There are some very crude drawings, insults, 10 languages.
But there's nothing to touch. There's nothing that looks like a...
Just eyeballing it, you don't see anything, just checking it out.
I'll put my hand on it.
All right.
And before we move past this, Brendan, can you describe in better detail the really crude drawings?
Absolutely. So imagine if this was... Wait, what? I'm being told by our producer to knock it off. Okay, so I'm going to stop right now. They're crude. That's what I got to say about that.
There are two very prominent taggers in Providence right now who I love. There's one that it's imagine the word NASCAR without the N. And it is dripped, and it's drawn like a car that has one, right? And then there's another guy that just tags horny everywhere, and which reminds me of like Beach Street and Spit, right? Like he would just tag Spit, and it would not even be like artistic.
Yeah.
That's how this is. It's just horny.
Am I the only person that wants them to have a meet cute?
Yeah.
I ship it.
It's so dumb, but when I lived in Seattle, there was one I loved. There are all these street signs that said, stop for me, it's the law, and like the person walking past it. But somebody was going through them and putting a C in front of the word L and drawing the big claw on the other hand. He's like, stop for me, it's the claw. Like this guy with this big claw hand.
It's not even offensive, it's just funny.
It's so dumb, but like I would just howl with laughter every time I saw it.
We have a local guy, and I have a picture of it. I think the name is Derek, but it says, and every once in a while you'll find this, and it says, Derek is above average. Now that's just funny. I don't care who you are.
That's knowing your own limits. That's being very self-aware.
Derek's above average. Like he's not going to talk too much.
He's above average.
I mean, really, let's face it, Derek. We all know Derek's actually only slightly above average, but we'll let him leave the slightly out.
You know, yeah, so nothing but love. All right, so crude. We take a look at the crude drawings drawn upon here, but we don't see anything. You know, it's just various levels of crude.
Most of it's funny.
Is there, yeah.
We all taste it. We're like, oh, you see that? Okay, nice. is there anything like a keyhole or anything that I can find just from looking without?
Give me an intelligence check. All right.
Just looking without touching.
Oh, are there any bonuses? No, just 12.
Yeah, total of 12. Just looking at it, you're not really seeing anything.
I start touching and groping and rubbing my hands all over the wall and the column.
I stand back.
And my owl, who I have a telekinetic connection with, I'm also going to have fly up and push its talon into the skull and try to try all those various things.
He doesn't know why, but he goes up there and he kind of scrabbles across it, and you know he's doing that. However, as Ka'a is feeling around there and like running her hands over it, you find two stones under layers of graffiti, each one that have a little bit of give, just a tiny bit. But it feels like these two stones that are within, like you can get them, touch them both at the same time, and they're a little bit over your eyeball level. You feel like the two of these things can both move a little bit.
Does it feel like they come out or that I push them in? Or it
feels like they push in.
I'm going to push them both in same time.
You push.
You're really getting into it.
Jeff's new band.
You know what? I'm going to say, man, just as that reminder of Michael Curtis, I think as a player that bold action by Ka'a deserves some fleeting luck.
I'll offer you fleet luck for that. Oh, sorry, I lost my window.
I'll take it. That brings me up to 3, I believe, right?
Yeah. Who's in the Twitch stream? I forgot to open my window up here.
I'm in the Twitch stream.
We got Tony and Sky2 and then
Sky2!
My Little's there.
There's somebody named Hobbs who's loitering. Somebody should probably call security. Hobbs?
Yeah. That guy.
Wait, does Hobbs have his own emoji? Is that
That's a Brett emoji. That's a little. Those are little Brett Blazinski.
Oh no! But yeah, if you go look up, then there's also Hobbs.
Oh, there is a little Hobbs emoji.
There's like cartoon Hobbs and real Hobbs.
God.
Oh, that's upsetting.
Hey, Hobbs, did somebody make you that or?
I don't see that at all. That's amazing, though.
I'm giving him hell.
Our audience too. Please, please rewind Brendan to give us luck.
Yes, remind me. What's up, Mike Little? Take a point of fleet and luck for being so bold. So Ka'a presses on these two things at once, and suddenly, sure enough, a section of wall swings outward. It opens, it grinds open, blowing a cloud of dust and cobwebs into your faces. Like Ka'a, like you feel the blessings of the spider, of Mog the spider, as these cobwebs fall across your face and chest like a benediction. They're just all there upon you. And but here it goes. So as this thing opens, y'all hear this like something inside the door just completely screwed up. So it opens a certain amount and then it stops, like dead stops.
Also, I want to say, if I see a little spider as well, like from the cobwebs, I'm going to kind of give it a little look and be like,
gotcha. Yeah, but you kind of feel them nodding in appreciation to you as you go through there. Yeah. Wob, wob, wob.
So does the door only go up a bit, Brendan, and then just like maybe like a few feet, like enough for us to crawl through type thing?
Or it kind of opens up it opens like this.
Okay.
You can kind of sideways get in through there with your backpacks and everything.
I want to oil the hinges.
I was going to say, can we take a
look? You have oil?
I do. I have lantern oil. I have 3 flasks.
Sure. You know what? You can do that. Also, give me a disabled device check while you do it.
Oh, sweet. Uh, 19.
All right. You oil those hinges up real nice. However, you realize the hinges are not the issue. This thing is probably not open for hundreds of years, and what you think happened is that there was a collapse, but the counterweight that would make it open and shut has probably collapsed in on itself just from disuse, the rope probably burning through. So at this point, without like actually getting in there and doing some mechanical stuff, this door is stuck open. It cannot be shut normally. Problem is, like behind you is, I mean, it's kind of empty right now because you just had a big gang fight like 100 feet from here and everyone's hidden scared, but it's only going to last so long.
Can I try some mechanical stuff?
Yeah, you can give me a to shut it behind you.
Yeah, to sort of like maybe fix the counterweight. Like, yeah, can I shove something else in there?
You can give me. It's going to take a few minutes, and if you can give me a DC 20 disabled device, I will let you fix the counterweight issue and be able to shut the door back behind you.
Can I have it all, or is this a job?
I will say you can help. So what we do, the way I do this, this is my own, the way I do it, both of y'all can roll like your disabled device check. 10, like the highest number is the actor. The other person gets a 10 or better on their check, they can add +1 to the higher number.
Let's go for it.
Okay.
All right. It'll cut your distraction. Time
down. Haley, sure, what do you want?
I was quite useless. Not a 1, but a 5.
Okay.
I only rolled a 15.
Okay, what's Lucarx going to do for distraction?
Oh, I'm going to pretend I belong. Did I pick up any spider gang lingo or signs?
Didn't you grab? You know what? You know their whistle.
Okay, so I'm going to make it look like I'm one of them. So if any of the locals try to come by, I'm like, go the other way.
All right,
I see you. Go the other way.
Okay.
So, yeah, Carmen, you needed a 20, but you got a 15?
Yeah, but I can burn some luck.
Yeah, I'm willing to throw in all 3 of my fleeting luck if anybody wants to put in 2 more.
I have one I can
spend. Okay.
I'll throw in 1.
Carmen, if you spend your own fleeting luck, you'll get your luck die, right?
Oh, yeah. Thank you. I always forget that.
Oh, yeah. So, Haley, go ahead and hold on to yours for the time being.
Yeah.
4 on my die.
19.
Okay, then
you just get 1 from Jeff,
and I'll give you 1. Yeah, exactly.
All right, so Mara and Kai Hala have to monkey around in the interior of this thing for a little while. It's a pain. You have to get this panel back and get your arms in there. It's literally no one has been back inside this thing for like 100 years minimum. It's all dusty and rusty, but you have oil with you. You know, like you can see down below where the counterweight is. So you have to like reach down all the way to your shoulder. You can barely get it up there. You kind of like give it like a quick job, sort of like wrap it up around the thing again. So that counter lever gets put back in place, and you think you can shut the door back behind you once you're inside, and it'll like you can see from the interior, you'll be able to. It won't be a problem to open it from the interior. It doesn't seem to you to be, now that you've actually worked on it and spent some time with it, with the mechanics.
And is the interior of this thing like super dark? Obviously.
Oh, it's it is super dark indeed.
And when we had the door open, would there look to be any sconces or lanterns or candelabras or anything available, or do I need to light my own?
No, you're gonna have to bring some kind of light in there. Here is what I will say: there's enough light that you can kind of see a little bit into that stair, into that chamber while everyone is looking inside here. Okay, so here's what you see: beyond the secret entrance is a square, dusty chamber. Every surface is covered by an inch thick carpet of dust. A winding stone staircase rings the walls of the room, rising up into the gloom. Aside from your breathing, the room is silent, but you have the uncomfortable sensation that something lies within, slumbering fitfully.
Before anybody lights any torches or any lanterns, I would like to cast a spell. If that's all right with everybody. All right. I'm going to go ahead and cast a spell. And I rolled a natural 1. On my, I was rolling Ekim's mystical mask, which could give me infravision, but nope, one. So I lost, fail, and worse. Roll a d6 modified by luck.
And we all lose our fleeting luck.
Yep. What's that?
I took away the tokens.
Fleeting luck.
Everybody loses their fleeting luck.
Thanks.
Sorry, I was trying to be helpful. Okay, so rolling 6 modified by my current luck, which is going to be an 8. So that's a -1. So it takes me down to a 3. A 3 is, it's modified in the other direction. That's right. Because low is bad, right?
Mm-hmm.
So yes, low is bad. So I got a 2. So it's corruption.
Yeah, so please go ahead and roll me a die 4.
I'm going to get sooty hands again.
3.
All right. Ooh. This is actually really interesting, this one. The caster develops a phobia about revealing their true face and takes to wearing veils or hooded cloaks.
Okay.
Congratulations. You know, I was just thinking Ka'a needed some more weird nonsense about his person. So, hey, you know what? Like, all this whole Mask of Lankhmar thing is making you think, Mask.
Yeah, so I'm now obsessed with the idea of the mask that I end up getting as a part of my prize is something that I'm going to have to wear to cover my face. But until that happens, I'm going to go ahead and tear off a portion of my robe, of my soot covered, even though I don't make soot anymore. I've still got soot all over my robes from before. I'm going to tear off a strip of my soot covered robes and kind of tie it around my face and make little eye holes.
Don't you have like fancy silk cloths?
I was going to say, who's going to sell those?
I have very fancy white silk cloths, but they are not on me. They are in storage right now, and I'm looking for the right buyer.
Yeah, it's after Labor Day. No one wears white.
And just so happens that when Ka'a tears his robe, they turn into chaps.
Dun, 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 dun.
You may light your torches.
I think we've had more corruption so far in this campaign than we did in the entire first season of Blades. Am I right?
Yeah. Jeff's been hit twice now.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had the odd misfire, but not a whole lot of corruptions. So, congratulations. Yeah. Anyway, long story short, congratulations.
Go ahead.
Oh, I was going to ask if I could use disguise self on another person.
Sure.
Yeah. Do you want some help with your disguise with your mask?
Yes, please.
Okay. I'm not really sure what this will do, but.
So, are you trying to make it look like not a mask? Because that's going to be tricky. Or are you trying to make it look like a different kind of a mask?
He's wearing someone's face. Like Goodbye Horses style.
Gotcha.
Christmas Story, the robbers that like come over the fence kind of thing. I don't know if you guys know what I'm talking about. That's what I'm envisioning.
Right? Like a domino mask?
Yeah, yes. They have something like...
And then they'll get the little X, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, all right. 15?
yeah, with the help of some cloaky stuff, he just looks like a quick glance, Ka'a looks like he's just wearing, has like a very straight, like a very, either super pale or super dark complexion, depending on what you use to do it with. And, his eyes still show. And you kind of make a point of having where, like, you cut it so his mouth can still show. That's the key, is having the mouth out of there. So, like, it covers him, but not, like, covers him.
Okay.
Well,
like Mr. Miracle.
While Mauro is doing that, Brendan, I'll lit the torch.
Gotcha, you lit that torch. And Skatch, what's Sep is up to? P.S. Sep has one of his spells, and feels his personality shift yet again.
And the creepy Sep is
worried. Haley's a little worried because last time I played him as a creepy little dude. No, I was just going to ask if there was something around the outside that I could use to kind of make a makeshift torch because I don't have any.
Absolutely, yeah. There's so much clapboard nonsense out here. I mean, you can definitely find something. You know, an oily rag and a piece of stick that you can make a torch with, no problem.
Thank you.
As long as someone can make fire.
Yeah, I have flint and steel, but I just don't have any.
Gotcha. Yep. You hook up a little homemade torch. All right, so 10 minutes in, and we now have a door that can open and shut on the front of this thing, a secret door.
Guys, forget treasure. I think we have a new business plan.
Yeah, professional door openers and closers.
And we sell makeshift torches. I'm gonna stick the torch in and then have Mino kind of wander in a little bit to see. He can telepathically communicate, so let me know what else, if there's anything else in the room that we should be worried about.
Right. He comes in, so he like creeps in a little bit and like telepathically to you, he's like, know people for a long time. It's quiet in here, not a lot of ways out.
That's a good point. I didn't think about that. I can also have Bama fly in there because me and Bama, he's an owl.
Yeah.
Owls can see in the dark.
Bama flies through and is like, except for that one thing you told me I'm not allowed to eat. This place, this place, there's not much here to be seen, but Master, you must be cautious. for there's danger within. I can sense it, something unnatural. And you're getting the same thing back from your rat too. It's like, something strange. I sense it, something strange. Beware, beware, Septus, beware.
Wait, I thought he was a minotaur. He's a rat?
He's a
minotaur. He was traumatized. He thinks he's a minotaur because he was run through the mazes so many times. Mm-hmm. He's like the minotaur
of men. That's fantastic.
He has like little horns. Yeah, he wears little horns.
He made his own little version. Either way, as soon as Bama goes flying in, he's just going to kind of hang his head, turn around, and like be flipping the bird as he walks back out towards me, like, oh, that's not it.
He's been upstaged.
I will lead the way unless one of the thiefy types wants to, and I'll hold the torch for them, or I can go first and kind of like.
I can go first and check for traps.
Yeah, all right, so I'll stay behind so that way. I'll illuminate it for you, but also be close enough.
I feel like you were our meat shield too much last season.
I mean, I have a good amount of hit points.
I think you've taken more damage than all of us combined so far.
Yes, yes. Okay, so going forward, checking for traps as I go.
You're going to go up the stairs?
Yes.
All right, so go ahead and give me a check for traps roll as you on the stairs themselves as you make your way up there.
Okay. It's cocked and on the floor. I'm gonna re-roll.
Yeah.
Got a tiny, tiny desk.
I understand.
9, 10, 11.
You don't see any traps. The staircase has got no railing. It's comprised of slabs of stone mortared directly into the walls, like floating shelf style stones, like just coming out of it and such. So it goes up as you look at it, it goes up to a landing, and then up to another landing where there is a door, which presumably is the next level of this thing. All right, we fixed it. Do we shut the door behind ourselves and go in, or are we?
Yeah.
Right. Yes.
Yeah. Once you guys shut the door in here, the air is incredibly, like, you let a breath of air in this place, but it's the air is incredibly still in here at this point. And it's just very, very close in here. There's a weird scent. Weird spices are in the air. There's a smell, like a really intense fenugreek smell coming from up above you guys.
Now, if I recall correctly, after the last at the end of the last episode, there was a big fight outside, right? Big gang fight out in front of this place, mm-hmm. and we know that there are at least one other. Somebody else is after the same thing we are right now, right?
Yeah, you were, Kai Halat actually caught a tail, somebody who was trying to join the Thieves Guild, and apparently this was their
hostage number one.
That was hostage number one.
As soon as we get in and she starts checking for traps, I'm going to turn around and cast Ward Portal on the door behind us.
And there's a door.
That's actual. I love that. Yeah, this spell is gonna perform as written one time. Yeah, do give me a check for whatever it's called, Ward Portal.
Please don't roll so high and then die, because then we might just be trapped in here forever.
No, it's let's see.
Put the words right out of my mouth.
Don't give him any ideas.
Okay, I got an 18 total, so the portal is held in place for 2d6 times 10 hours. It cannot be opened by more teams, though a knock spell or powerful magical creature can open it.
Yeah, man. So you have shut this thing down properly. So
let's hope there's another exit.
Let's
50 hours.
Yeah.
Nice.
Only one way to find out.
I'm going to.
I didn't know if I rolled it or you.
No, you roll that. You roll that. Okay. And then Jeff.
I'm going to put my feet firmly in the ground and stand there boldly as I cast Detect Magic.
Okay, go ahead.
And that is a 7.
Yeah.
So I've lost that spell for the day.
Yeah. Fun. You're having a rough one.
Well, you're really good at this, Ty.
I believe in you, okay? I believe in you. So,
so what's on this first floor here?
All right, there's this room is really the only thing in here. There's a stairway going up, and like I said, just a thick, like a literal inch of dust on absolutely every surface across the entire room, all the way up on the stairs and everything. So the stairs go like up to a landing, and then up to a landing where there's a door. But other than that, it's empty.
Can I write Kai was here?
You can absolutely write Kai was here in the dust on there.
I would like to make a very crude drawing.
No problem. If you're watching at home, I want you to just clear your minds for a moment and imagine what Jeff Goad thinks a very crude drawing is. Just let that wash over you. Just
you.
The first stick figure is
it's not just feet. I just pictured the sleeping guy.
Oh. I just want to write horny in mingle.
Yeah, I'm just gonna write
weirdly enough, it's actually horny. It's the same, you know, it's a weird coincidence. It's a borrow word from English. So that reminds me, my favorite Rhode Island graffiti was a Cosmo, which we kept seeing all over the place. That actually freaked me out after a while. I'm like, does he know something? I don't know. Mm-hmm. All right, so you guys, after spending some time tagging, the proper term, this room here in the dust and, you know, marking up stuff and such. So I got to make a note here. So, we have Kai Hala was here. Kai was here.
I'm putting Kai. I'm not being very specific. I'm being slightly specific.
Sure.
That I can't make credit for it, but people can't 100% blame me.
Oh, I know. I'm just, what language?
I will do desert talk. Little diff.
And also, underneath the very crude drawing that I drew, I'm going to go ahead and write someone's name underneath it. And specifically, one of my dooms is I have a blood price on my head because of, like, I accidentally led this revolution against this, like, dictator in my desert land. I'm going to write his name underneath the crude drawing.
I miss you for a good... For a good time.
I know that could accidentally lead a rebellion.
I know, right?
It wasn't my fault. It wasn't my fault.
He almost pulled it off. He just didn't print enough flyers, as it turns out.
Things just sandballed out of control. And
outstanding.
That's what we say in the desert lands. We don't have snow, so there's no snowballing. It's all sandballing.
I likes it. All right, so what's the next step?
I gotta check for traps before we go up the stairs. Second pick.
All right, give me a check for traps roll on the stairs themselves.
Sheesh. I have to turn on a light. I can't see nothing. 13. But let me spend. Oh, wait, we don't have any more fleet left, do we? Never mind.
We could get a low opinion if we really think we need it.
13's pretty good. You go 13? You
can 13. Spend
real I'm trusting it. I think we should just go. Let's all
let it ride.
All right. Yeah. I'm confident with this. All everyone right. Seems to be confident with my opinion.
Yeah, 13. It looks looks pretty good. There is a however, I will say this during your okay. We check all the way up to the door.
Yeah.
Right, wait, I will say
you, no. Well, how many flights? You said there's flights.
It's like one landing, right?
Yeah, so the stairs go up, so to like they kind of like go around you. So like landing, okay. And then the last landing there's a door there.
Okay. If we can make it to the door.
Do we have safety rails going up along the side as well?
No safety rails.
No. Not OSHA compliant. It is not OSHA compliant.
Who built this?
All right, I'll lead. I'll go.
All right, so Kai, with everyone else back behind you, Kai makes their way up to the door. Nothing happens. The stairs seem, you know, you make the stair. You know, there are a couple of stairs are missing, and you have to like kind of like you know the place is ancient. So in a few places you have to actually hop over from one step to another step. But
I agree with the person in chat. I think sandballed is.
Oh my God. All right.
Understandable. Yeah,
I also agree with the person in chat that we're actually just making our way to the best falafel stand in Lankhmar.
What I wouldn't give.
Thanks, Sky.
What I wouldn't give.
All right, so who did the sandballs? Who's getting that luck?
Yeah, take a point of fleeting there.
All right,
Elder Skatch.
Well, Sky 2, you'll always be
Jeff.
Oh, Jeff,
Jeff.
Sorry, my bad. All right, yeah, man. You guys, get up there to the thing. You said it smells very intense up there. And hey, wait, Sky 2, way to know the ingredients of falafel. I have to admit, I always I get the mix, so what could be in there. Chickpeas. The rest of y'all, we're up there at this door.
Wanna check for traps there, Kai?
Yeah, I was gonna say I'll get this one, guys.
All right. Get it a roll.
That's a nat 20.
Wow.
Take a point of fleeting luck, and the door, you take a really good careful look at this door. You are quite certain that it is not trapped. However, you have checked it out so carefully. You also know it to be locked, and I will give you a plus one on your open locks check on that because you have so thoroughly have you vetted it for traps.
We do have a key though, right? Does it look like the key would go in the lock or like I'm going to have to pick it?
This key is too big for this lock. This is like a regular lock, a bit old fashioned. The one that you have is like a big old like, ha-ha, it's the lock of magic.
Gotcha. All right,
with the soundtrack and everything.
I will try and pick lock.
I'll see you do it. Plus one.
Let's see. 12 on the die. Where is pick lock? Plus two. So 14, 15.
Yeah, 15. Yep, you are able to unlock this door, no problem. When you open it, that really intense spice smell is like even more so now. It's like you almost feel it, like the air is getting thick. You know what I'm saying? Like there's no like you're really kind of breathing very old air. And other than that 10 minute period that the door was open, it was the only like oxygen exchange that you had in here. So it's pretty. The air, you know, even at this point, this door is locked anyway. So the air up here is pretty stale. But when you are able to unlock, what'd you get on your open lock check?
15.
Yeah, no problem. You get it unlocked.
Is it like pumpkin spice?
No, it's like a very intense. You know what it's like?
Like the old master spice?
No, you know what? Ka'a, you know what it's Ka'a of the embalming spices of the desert.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, that kind of delicious chai smell of mummies.
Yeah, little vanilla. Yeah.
Oh, man. Anytime this happens in Lankhmar, I'm always like, oh, the guild masters are here. We're going to run into some.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
I don't even know what that could mean. But so here's what you see. The door opens up and you again that smell. Oof. You see dust-covered vestments hang from hooks along the walls of this small chamber. Unlit torches stand in brass sconces on both the north and east walls. Also on these walls are two rows of full face masks carved from some dark wood. An ancient moldering rug spans the floor beneath a layer of gray dust, and a door exits the room on the south wall.
Can you describe these masks to us?
I'd be happy to. These are, each mask represents an angular female face and is carved with great skill from some kind of, it's very dusty right now. Do you take one down and inspect it?
We'd have to walk over the rug to get there, right?
You could creep along, like carefully creep along the outside of it, one person at a time. There's a small gap around the outside of it. So if you were to walk that gap as if it were a ledge carefully like that, then yeah, you could make it to where the masks are without actually, you know, zapping yourself.
You know what? I feel like, right now, Kaha is, so focused on A, getting a mask for Mog, and now B, getting a mask for himself, that against my better judgment, I'm just stepping forward to grab one of the masks to start inspecting it.
All right,
I grab by his collar. I don't let him do that.
You are being held back from
over there. I allow for that to happen.
Okay, gotcha. Yeah. All right, allow yourself to be checked.
I'll detect traps since I'm the one. It's like, hey, hold up.
You want to check the rug? Yeah, check the rugs out. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Dude, but this seems like a bad idea.
You were right, my friend. You were right.
But I don't see nothing. So. That's a six.
Well, so here's what happens. You start investigating that rug, and you get down there to look, and you, out of the corner of your eye, you see a flurry of movement. You look up, and suddenly the robes on that wall, they are moving. You don't see any bodies in them or anything, but they all kind of like, as one, they all sort of like rise up off their pegs. They seem to, something is filling them out. This, you kind of see this vague, see-through kind of, it almost looks like some combination of water and air, this weird ethereal material that seems to be certainly, you know, not real and yet real, not tangible, but like certainly something with power, fills up these robes, and they all start moving towards y'all at once, and with their empty sleeves reaching for you. There are five of them, and let us roll initiative.
Are these NFTs?
But you, it, was your detect magic still going?
That was a.
No, you lost it.
That was my. That was my. Oh no, that wasn't my fumble, but that was just a fail.
Yeah. All right, I'm gonna go around top to bottom. Tim, what'd you get for initiative?
I got a 20.
Cool. And remind me your character's name again, please.
Gonbatar.
Outstanding. Lukark, how'd you do?
Got a five.
Five for Lukark.
I haven't rolled higher than six yet today.
Just getting them out of the way early. That's right. Fine.
No problem. Mara the Thief, how did we do?
18.
Thanks, Tim. 18 for Mara. Okay, Kai Hala.
I also got a 20.
20? Who should go out of, who has a high agility? Gambitar and...
I'm at a nine.
All right, Kai Hala is first. For Septus, how'd you do?
Lucky seven.
Lucky seven. Dun, dun, dun. And never least, how'd you do for Ka'a and Bwama?
I believe this is my first non-sucky roll of the night. I got a 17.
Look at you. You're a rock star. Okay, I didn't even roll the bad guys yet. I need to
Tony head. Says, in Soviet Lankhmar robes wear you.
So here's the deal. They got an 18, so they're going to go after Mara, but before what? Ka'a. I know, I'm sorry.
I get my first decent roll of the night.
I'm going to tell you, I'm going to fire over here. I'll fire.
You know, no, hold on. I'm spending my fleeting luck to increase mine. I'm not letting them go first. I'm not wasting my first good roll of the night.
You got it. So it will go Mara. So then the order, final order is going to be Kai Hala, Gambitar, Mara, Ka'a, whatever these things are, you know, pair of green pants, nobody inside of them, Septus, and then Lukark. Amen.
Non-fungible robes.
I'll take that seriously. Yeah. All right, so Kai, you go first. So they are coming off the wall. Like the closest one is 15 feet, the farthest one's about 25 feet. As they're kind of a raid on the pegs across the wall from the door, and next to the only other door in here. Again, empty robes, dust sort of trailing off of them. This weird kind of swirling. We don't know what's in the middle of them. Empty sleeves reaching out for you. What are you gonna do?
All right, and this was like staircase, door, room, correct?
Yeah, so when you open up the door here, okay, when you look across the wall, like across, like from the wall that you're standing at where the door is, on the opposite wall, there are the pegs with the robes, and then the door is over on the far side of that room.
Mm-hmm. Hiding shadows. There's seven of us and five of them. I'm gonna hide.
I got you, go ahead and give me a check.
Oh, first garbage roll on this die, let me see. That would be an eight.
Kai Hala, you are perfectly hidden, and we'll be fine on this round.
Gone. You guys have no idea. Which fools.
Gambitar.
All right, so since I had the torch in my hand, and I feel like even throwing it to draw and then shoot a bow is probably too much for one action, I'm going to throw the torch at the closest one, hoping in my deed, hoping for it to like actually light it on fire.
You know, light it on fire. All right. Go ahead and give me your attack roll. Add your deed die on top of that. And it's a range attack, so also add your agility mod.
I got a 17 to hit, but only a 2 on the deed.
Okay, so that's cool though. So I'm gonna call this. It's gonna do a die. So you're gonna do torch damage to it, and not like absolutely emoliate it. So you can go ahead and roll me a die 4 damage. Add your D die on top of that, and but give me that separately. The die and the deed number, please.
Sure. All right. So the die is 3.
All right.
And then the deed was 2, so it's 5 total.
Okay, so Gambitar steps in there and throws his torch at the closest floating rope. This thing catches up like flash paper. You know, a moment later, it's sort of like burns to tatters there in the air. It kind of falls down with your torch. And now it and your sputtering torch are on the floor on the edge of that rug across away from you. There are only 4 left, though. That one is completely burnt down.
Nice.
All right, which is awesome. So it is Mara and then Ka'a.
I saw what Gambitar did. I thought it was a really good idea. Can I throw 2 unlit flasks of oil?
If you're going to throw 2 unlit flasks of oil, I'm going to have that be... what do you call it?
Like 2 weapon fighting.
Two weapon fighting. So what's your agility?
Oh yeah, 2 weapon fighting.
15.
So on a 15 agility. On a 15 agility, so you'll be rolling a die 16 with your primary hand, and a die 14 with your offhand, and you can't crit with either of them. And so you're going to actually throw these oil flasks at them, I guess, with the idea of getting them oily so that next round they can get fired up.
Yeah, we're like close enough to the sputtering torch that
you might get lucky and
the issue
is that they you don't like looking at them. It's going to be to actually like break your oil flask. You're going to have to hit these things hard enough that they actually sort of like hit the wall, but like kind of like push the thing out and hit the wall behind it. It's possible, but it's going to be tricky.
Okay, so a die 14 and a die 16?
Yes, die 16 with your good hand and add your agility modifier, die 14 with your other hand. And then are you throwing both at one robe or at 2 different robes?
2 different robes.
2 different robes. I want to see you do it.
You made me nervous.
I mean, you know, it's... But I mean, this is some heroic awesomeness out here. I mean, don't be nervous.
Here's the blessing of the cat butt.
The blessing of the cat butt. a 9 and a 4.
Alright, so both of those are gonna miss.
We have a ruined.
Do they break?
Well, let's get into some luck checks, shall we? Okay. Why don't you roll me luck check twice?
Okay. 5.
Make it. One of them gently slides down this thing and lands on the rug perfectly.
It just sort of moisturizes it.
And it just kind of rolls off a lot. Just kind of bangs off it, but doesn't, you know.
Okay.
You can pick it up later.
And a 20. A dirty 20.
And a dirty 20. That one straight hits the wall behind this thing. And now you've got a broken oil flask along that back wall, like just smearing across the top of it.
Okay.
So, but that was some heroic awesomeness, and I appreciate you going for it with the big move. And that's when Ka'a gets to do something Ka'azy.
All right. Yes, time to be amazing. So what I'm going to do at this moment is I'm going to start anointing my wrists with fine oils. And then calling upon Mog and saying, Mog, assist me in my time of need. And I'm going to start casting Magic Missile, but I'm going to use my patron die while I do it.
All right, bet.
This is my first time using that mechanic.
Yes, I'm not sure, I'm interested in seeing how it's going
to... Okay, so, oof. So, my patron die needs to be equal to or below my d20, is that correct?
That's my understanding of it.
Okay, so with that, I roll the 5 on my d, this gives me a +4... 5, 9, 10, 11. An 11 would be a loss or a failure. I'm not going to let that happen. I'm going to spend, and I don't have any fleeting luck. I'm going to spend a real luck point to get me up to the bare minimum.
12.
And one of them is going to take a point of damage.
Gotcha.
I'm like, Mog, I'm right here trying to get your mask for you. Jeez.
Where's the love? Where's the love? How many times a day can you do that?
I can do it as often as I want, but if my patron die is higher than my d20, then the patron die starts to increase, and then it gets harder and harder and less likely to actually pay off.
All right.
I believe.
Mm. Right. I'll have to review that. I read it, and now I'm like... I read a lot of Lankhmar stuff this weekend, so. All right, but that is no worries for anyone.
Yeah, I think it's just like, I mean, I know this isn't, my example's out Lankhmar, but I think it's like how Elric is always like yelling for Arioch and be like, I'll bring you souls.
But do you actually have Invoke Patron?
Yeah, I do have Invoke Patron, but that one I can only cast twice a day, and I have cast it twice today.
Because I was going to ask you a question about that, but we'll play it out.
It'll come back.
Yeah. King Mob says, do the patron die till it works, then don't do it. Then you don't do it. Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
I mean, that's as fine a strategy talk you're going to get today. Don's in the house. DC, everyone check out DC Legacy and check out ReaverCon, which is coming up in... week after next, so I'm running some stuff there. It's gonna be awesome. All right, so Ka'ath throws a missile. You do some damage to one of them, but the rest of them can go. So the one that you hit with your missile, that one comes right after, flies right up to Ka'ath, and it is coming at you with its flappy arms, and he gets a natural one. That's terrible.
I like it.
I mean, he can't really fall.
Does he
down
trip over his own robes?
Yeah, do all the other robes laugh at him?
He turns. His crush is there.
He looks all like, he looks all like, oh, hang God. His hand starts to fray a little bit. It's just embarrassing. The other three, I'm gonna roll. Mara, nobody likes an oil thrower. One's coming at Mara. Ghost makes no noise. And that one is going to get a 13. Does the 13 get Mara the Thief?
Yes.
All right. So you are going to take the low damage of 2 points.
It's still a lot at my level.
Yeah. Well, and here's what happens. It also wraps itself around your face. Like it wraps its sleeves around there and is beginning to smother you.
You would like that.
That's true. I am looking for something just like that.
Well, today could be your lucky day. All right. There are two more. So that's the one that went after Mara. So I'm going to say they didn't like the oil flask attempts, but they really didn't care for the actual flaming attack. So one's coming at Gambatar, same thing. I was going to get a 15. Is that catching?
That'll do it.
All right. So you're going to take 3 points of damage. And once again, you are wrapped up. One of these things is wrapped around your face. All right. The last one I'm going to roll randomly, except for, let's see. Boom, 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 boom. All right. So will I have one, two, three?
Like a really aggressive thunder shirt.
So you know what else, I got my speaking of which, I have my, this is one of my
MEPACON shirts, because MEPACON is this weekend. I'll be running games at MEPACON. As the last time I looked, I had slots open. So come play an online game with me in the electric city of Scranton. All right, that's a very cool con, and I recommend throwing some love its way. The last one, Kai Hala, your hiding place is perfect. What the hell? How did that thing see you? It only gets an 8. I'm assuming it's a miss.
That is a miss.
But it just comes right down on you in your hiding place there, and it's trying to smother you with its big old sleevey sleeves.
It was going for someone else. It can't see me.
Fog of war. That's all of them, and it's time for Septus. Septus, I got guys trying to strangle your buds here. You gonna let that kind of nonsense go on?
Yeah, probably. I am going to... boy, I was mad when somebody did this to me, but I think I'm going to do it. One of them fumbled, right?
Yeah, the one that went after Ka'a just completely ate it.
Well, it pains me to help Ka'a out, but I will take a bug out of my little pouch of bugs and gobble it down, and then I will cast Flaming Hands.
All right.
Nine,
not a six. Oh well.
18 plus. Hold on a minute. 21. Spell produces a blast of fire that burns up to 3 targets within range for 1d6 plus caster level points of damage. All targets must be within 10 feet of another. So I'll take any 3 I can get.
That, you know what? I will say that won't
hurt. That won't also hurt my friends.
Well, that's funny. So you can get the one that went after Ka'a didn't right. get anyone. And the one and that went after Kai didn't get anyone. So there are 2 that are unengaged. However, the one that went after Mara still wrapped around Mara's head. One that went for Gambitar still wrapped around Gambitar's head. You can target one of them, but they'll probably take at least some fire damage.
Yeah, I will just focus on the 2 that are... All right,
so you're just going to pull it and just get those 2?
Yeah.
I respect you for that. Take a point of fleeting luck for not burning your friends to death, which I might have been tempted to do. So you go ahead and roll me damage twice, please. So the first one's going to be the one that went after Ka'a.
Yeah, that's only 2 points of damage.
Yeah, that is still up. It burns up pretty good. It is still going. Roll me the other one.
The other one got 3 points of damage.
Yeah, that's the one that's after, that is this one. So 3 points. So, I mean, they're both burnt up pretty good. Don't mistake it. You know what I'm saying? Like, you definitely did some damage to them, but they are still up and going. So, that was cool. And, fight is going to continue, and it is time for Average Man. Time for Common Man, Lukark. Dude, I want to get the fanfare for the Common Man to play every time it's a turn.
For the Common Man. Yeah, I'm going to go up to... I'm going to go and take the one that's wrapped around Mara's head, and I'm just going to go and try to rip it off her face and rip it in half if I can. I'm not sure if I'm strong
enough. All right, so go ahead. This is going to be like a grapple attempt, so just go ahead and give me a strength check to remove. All right.
Ooh, a 3.
Oof, yeah, that's gonna not do it. You go over there, you're pull, like, you like rip it a little bit, like, but you don't actually like get it at anything off of Mara. Like, so
yeah, I'm just imagining. But
you made me an air hole. It's cool.
Trying.
If only it was up by your mouth closer, you'd be in the hizzy. But way to help out and try to rescue somebody. That's awesome. I'm gonna give you a fleet luck point for helping out your fellow thief. You know what? Because we're doing today's team building. I love it. You know what I mean? Team building.
I was gonna say the bar was so low earlier. It was like you chose not to purposely hurt your friends. You're so luck. Like,
yeah, I'm encouraging. You know, so I don't spend the whole year educating in party fights and backstabbings.
I'm not doing that trust fall thing with you people though. Not happening.
What about virtually?
Not even.
That's even worse. I'm just gonna start doing that to him in the house now. I'm just gonna start like trust fall. Hitting the ground though, like hard. Yep. Like
Just don't
virtual trust ball needs to be the name of like an online club or something like that. That'd be awesome. All right, guys. Hey, we're at the top of the order, round two. Kai Hala, from your hiding spot, this thing just tried to murder you. What the hell?
Yeah, well, I'm still clearly so hidden, so I'm going to try and attack it from my hiding spot.
Right.
That is working really well. But
It's a sneak attack.
Yeah, sneak attack. I need my D16 now. But I have two weapon fighting, so I'm going to try and, you know.
All right. Yeah, what your minuses
are. Oh, man, I got a lot of dice. That's a... You got them? Sorry, technical difficulties. Okay, I found one.
This one's one, too.
Perfect. All right. Well, I got a 3 and a 15.
All right, that 15 is going to hit.
All right. Why can I never find the dice I need? Jeez. All right.
I think the ones you need, like, to hide.
Yeah. The whopping 2 points of damage.
You know what, though? Between that and the fire damage that it took, you actually destroy it. So, well done, ye. So, that's awesome. And then Gambatar. Gambatar, I got this thing wrapped around your face and trying to just do you wrong, baby. Do you wrong.
So, can Gambatar, remembering where he threw that torch, essentially sprint over in that direction and then just kind of like power slam his face onto it?
Yeah. You got to give me a, you can roll me a die 16 because you can't, you kind of have to like, you're using the force. You know what I'm saying? You're flying by instruments.
No, that's just how Mingles do it.
It's just how Mingles do it, baby. Mingles roll a D16. I don't want to tell you.
Roll me a D16
plus your D die. What now?
Don't I have seven Mingles somewhere?
Oh yeah, you know, dude. Here's a smash cut. Smash cut to seven Mingles going through your record collection. Crap.
Is this a strength based roll, Brennan?
Yeah, this would be like a die 16 regular attack roll.
Okay, and, so
I guess, yeah, it'd be strength. Yeah.
All right, so I got a 16 total with a 3 on the deed die.
Beauteous. So roll me that damage. It's gonna be a die 4 plus your 3 on top of that.
What does that carpet feel like?
Oh, so the die 4 is a...
He should fall through. Whoa!
No strength on it, though, right? Like straight die 4?
Nah.
All right. Yeah. So it's 2 points of damage.
All right. So here's the deal. All right. And then that includes your deed die?
No, the deed die is an additional 3.
So here is what happened. You slam this thing on there. You were still attached. So I am going to say that you are going to take... you take 2 points of burn damage doing it. But you destroy this thing in the process. So there are two left. There is the one that is wrapped around Mara's head, and then the one that our magic missile last time that is still in front of him and took some fire damage. Hey, so
not to blow my own horn, but Sky 2 thinks I should get luck for doing it Mingle style.
I think he should get
Mingle luck. Style. I'll take a point of luck for Mingle style. If Sky 2 says so, Sky 2 is my boy, man. So, what's up, Sky? Sky, you get a point of fleet and luck, too. So I think you should go ahead and, I don't know, ask for a raise or something. Or try to, I don't know.
Who is Sky, too? Do we know?
I do, and I had it in my head to remember, and now I can't. I can't keep up with handles anymore. Y'all have heard, like, once I'm emperor of the world, everyone gets to choose their handle, and that's what they use for everything, including what everyone will call you from now on. You'll only use your birth names amongst, like, you know.
Like the legal documents.
Yeah, you know what I mean? It'll be friend.
Yeah. So basically, when you rule the world, there'd be a lot of bureaucracy. A lot of paperwork, a lot of registry of names.
One time. But you know what, though? It'll be worth it.
But what if somebody else already has your handle and you have to add, like, this really stupid number to the bottom?
I already got it figured out. 1, 2, 3, 4, I declare a thumb war. Only way it's fair.
Also, what if you grew out of one? Like, I remember in 2000, my email address was feversandmirrors@yahoo.com.
That's boss.
You have to have a hearing.
And like,
That's Cuckmaster 13.
So, okay, new rule. You have to keep whatever embarrassing handle you had in middle school.
I have mine on my Snapchat, and it's awkward.
The internet didn't exist when I was in middle school.
Yeah,
I was going to say.
It did when I was in middle school with unfortunate results. XX RAR XD.
Not good. Middle school. Man, there was that whole year I tried to get people to call me Flash. That did not work out. Instead, I got my butt kicked a couple times.
They just invented D&D.
Now, want to be called Flash because you are fast or because you had a habit of, like, being naked at inopportune times?
Why not both? At the same time.
I was obsessed with the sci-fi Flash Gordon movie of the time. So,
we could call you Flash. We'll make it a
thing. No, it's all good. You know, it's
no, like, we'll make it a thing.
Too late. You know what? It's too late. If you there are other nicknames I've had since then I'd rather have than that one.
But it's not too late, Flash. It's just not.
Good old Flashless Hal.
Oh, that's terrible, isn't it?
Judge Flash. Terrible.
Hey, forget it. XXL, whatever.
XXL. Extra large roar.
That's pretty boss.
All right. So nickname talk. I've totally lost track of where we are.
You just won the fight.
I think I just power bombed my face into the torch.
Yes. So then it's Bingle style. Mara, and then so Mara.
I guess I'm gonna slap fight with myself. grapple it and try to tear it off.
All right, give me a strength check. But since it's wrapped around your head, you got to roll your strength check with a D16 rather than a D20.
But I know where my face is.
I'm going to tell you. Call Mike Curtis. It's the problem. It's not knowing where it is. It's literally unwinding it, and it's using your own strength against you. It's like jujitsu pants. Come on now, let me roll. D16.
Okay. All right. What's my strength? Okay. 16s keep rolling.
I know, right?
Hang on a second. I'll find it.
Like Fred Durst.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh my God. Okay, so we took that long journey across my studio to roll a one.
Mara swallows a button. Sleeve, it just goes down like an ice cube. You just have ingested it. Too late.
Oh no.
Oh man.
That's cool.
You can still work out and get a set of cufflinks, but at what cost? Alright, so that fails. This thing is still wrapped around your head and it is their turn. So what happens is you take an additional, I gotta reroll it, but the die is cocked. You take an additional 3 points of damage as this thing continues to throttle you. Mara goes down. Kaboom. Mm. And the other one,
Wait, I still have 1 point.
Somebody help out Mara. And there's left. This is the same one that went after Ka'a last time.
Wait, don't I go before them?
You do.
You spend a point. Yes, you do, sir. Yes, you do.
All right. So Ka'a is going to go ahead and I can fix this, guys. I know what's going on here. We just need to take these masks off the wall. This will fix everything. So I walk up and I take two of the masks off the wall, including the one that looks like it's the most powerful of the masks.
Okay. These ones all look pretty. I mean, you make a personal choice about what they
How many masks are there?
There are a total of...
I don't think these are
too much. Total of six.
And we were expecting seven, correct?
Yes. You were told that they were gilded and covered in diamonds and gems.
Oh, and these aren't gilded and covered in diamonds and gems?
Oh, no. Now that you have these two in your hand, they appear... Okay, a quick look. They are... They're some kind of fancy, like, slick wood. And they've got, like, they've got, like, fabric on the interior that covers the interior part over the nose and mouth, so...
Well, I'm going to go ahead and put one of them on, so now I've now got that mask over my cloth human face mask.
You got it. You've got like a cloth thing over on top of everything else. You have now two layers of cloth between that. It's a little hard to breathe, actual. Like, it's the air in here is closed. You got two layers and a regular mask. You're sweaty. Fight's going on. Mom's spaghetti. So the fight is going to continue. But so you have a mask and one attack Mara, and then the other one, you put the mask on, and then the one tries to get you. After you do that. So here comes that attack.
Plan didn't work.
I got a 12 that time. Did that get you?
Oh, AC 9. I'm so easy to hit right now.
Gotcha. You're going to take 2 points of damage, and you have a robe wrapped around your face.
Okay.
That's their whole go, though, and that's when Septus can step in and do something great.
Yeah, now, you'd think.
I don't know if you know how the rules work, but since you cast your spell correctly last time, you can cast it again this round. And just see how you do. I mean, I realize these things are both got people's faces wrapped up. Obviously, that's not the best of possible worlds.
So, there's one on Mara. Yeah? Mm-hmm. And there's one on Ka'a.
Yep.
Okay. So, definitely Mara. I'll go to the one on...
Wizard rivalry.
The Septus is petty. It's and more fun.
I will... I'm just going to try and use my dagger to kind of cut cut it open enough that she can breathe.
Go wrong here.
So on and so forth.
Yeah, gotcha. You're going to want to not fumble this one. We're going off books if it's a fumble.
Wow. I mean, it would be kind of funny if you did. So it's awesome, fine. But I'm just saying. I wasn't using this face much.
The wall we can replace it with. Well, it wasn't a fumble, but it was not a hit.
All right. Roll me one more attack roll, please. All right, what's your armor class?
11.
18.
Yeah. What's up?
Dude, that's gonna that one's going to leave a mark.
Yeah. Where is it? Hold still. I think I got it. Oh, that's a bad one. Mara had one hit point left, so Mara goes down.
I told you to stand still.
Oh, there you
I
go.
Just had flashes of Home Alone and the tarantula on the chest. Right? Or...
Oh, that's right, Mark. Gotcha. All right. Save the buzz on the other end. Might be a value. Gotcha. All right. So that was, that was obviously awesome. But you know what, though? You know what, though? It's time for Lucark to do some real good Lucarkin.
I look at Septus like, what did you do? But I'm going to run over and try to peel this thing off of Ka'a's face.
Gotcha. Go ahead. Give me a straight check, DC. We don't know.
You don't know? God damn it. 7.
Not 7.
Got it. Now, I'm inching up closer to the 10.
All right. You start trying to drag this thing off you.
Yeah, it's just, you. My hands are slippery.
It's throwing a floppy elbow at you.
Yeah. This,
so that didn't work out. But that's all right, though. It's top of the order, and it's time for Kai Hala.
What does the rug feel like since I'm running across it at this point?
Very old. It's so old that it's kind of, like, deteriorating a little bit under your feet even as you do this. Like, it's so rotted. Like, dry rot.
All
right. It's also shag.
That's what I was imagining.
It's got a great big kitten on the middle there, and it says, hang in there, baby, in high length Marie's.
So none of us know what it says.
All right. Kai Holler.
Yeah, this thing's still on Mara's face, right? Like, she's down on the ground and still...
Oh, yeah.
All right, my tactic is going to be, like, you know when you're shaking out a rug, and you kind of, like, blink it really hard. That's gonna be my tactic to try and rip it off her face.
Okay. You know what? Gonna go for like the laundry straighten on this thing. I'll show you what about robes. Go ahead and give me a strength check, and if it's close, I'm gonna give you it because you're finessing it.
Is a 3 close?
Y'all are gonna rip my face off.
It is not. And what happened? What happens is,
we have a Shanna sighting.
Right.
Shanna.
I cut that slit right across here, and now she just accidentally grabbed it and tore the front of your face off.
That's so
So now, one of those masks is going to be required.
Oh my god.
I'll get a Naruto headband.
We're going to what? Where the monsters dwell? All right, so Kyle, you go over there and grab this thing. The opposite of what you hope for happens. It definitely comes off, but it comes straight at your face. Ruff! So with Mara laying there, it feels like it can safely move on and try to murder somebody else. But we'll see.
Great, Mara, I got it.
I meant to do that.
I was so worried about you.
That's awesome, though. So, we'll see how this is going to play out. But that's when Gon Batar.
All right, I guess I'm going to try to stabilize Mara. Run over.
All right.
I'll just, like, you know, open the airway.
Point of luck, gotcha.
I think maybe like the Mingle tradition is to, like, lick your thumb and, like, wave it on their forehead as, like, a blessing. I don't know, like.
Man, I didn't know where you were going with that.
Be careful. You never want to go full Mingle.
You might, you know, they're tough.
Are tough.
All right, so that, you know, my action is just stabilizing.
You get a point. You're at 1 point and... You brought back Gambatar. That's a point of luck, and take a point of fleeting luck for rescuing Mara. That's awesome. And so I'm gonna say it's technically your turn now, but I'm gonna say you gotta spend you can go at the end of this round. You can go on initiative one this round if you want to actually act as things are happening. So you got a thing on your face.
Yeah, I don't like that. I'm gonna magic missile this thing. Let's see how that goes.
So, yeah. All right, time out. It's got your face wrapped around, okay?
Uh-huh.
That's gonna screw up your spell cast and just attach.
It's fine.
Listen, if you can, try and get the missile right into your mouth.
Oh, it only hits the target.
I was going to say, here's my argument here against me potentially taking any of that damage is magic missile is incredibly precise in what it targets.
As long as you successfully cast it, it's going to do just what you want it to do.
Okay. But I'm only rolling a d30, right?
Emphasis?
Yeah, opposite, though. Opposite. In fact, you can roll me a rock and roll d16, and that's me being ever so generous. I'm really one of 14.
Thanks, Brendan. Yeah. Okay, with my D16, I rolled a 5. That's exciting. Nothing happens. Except that I lose it. Oh, wait, I had already lost it. So I guess I'm going to say I spellburned a point to do that.
Spellburned a point, yeah. I assumed that was part of the...
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, that didn't go like we might have liked. But you know what, though? Fight goes on. And, hey, guys, if we have a TPK here today, you know what we'll do next week? Shutter Mountain. Wow.
Anyone else just imagining this in their head? Like, it grabs Mara's face, and then, you know, oh, no, stab, and then I rip it off, and it's on my face. Meanwhile, Ka'a's trying to shoot magic missiles at himself. Like, this is...
Yes, but add Benny Hill music.
Yeah, like,
going Carmen, down. You read my mind. I was going to say, we need yakety sax in the background, and it would be like...
It would be weird, like, peas in a pot.
This is like the first time I tried to do my own laundry at college. Went a lot like this. So, all right. So that was... Ka'a went, it is their turn. So that one is coming after Kai Hala. I'm going to get a total of a 9.
I will not do it.
All right. It like comes right at your head, but you duck out from under it. And now it's hovering behind you. Like it's you and it are whirling around as if it's looking for like a wrestling hold on you. And then the other one is still going after. It's still on. This one's still holding on to Ka'a. Ka'a, you take a further 2 more points of damage as this thing continues to shake your head about and throttle you.
Ew.
I know, right? Somebody stop him.
How rude.
Okay. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to go after. There's one by by Kai Hala, right?
Go for the one on Kai. I'm not grappled yet.
You're not grappled, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there's one grappling.
Actually Ka. Has Ka'a, yes.
Right. Yeah, I'm definitely going to go after the one that's on Ka'a.
Awesome.
With flaming hands again. So I'm gonna eat the bug. I'm going to eat the bug. Well, I mean, it's really, I saved Mara, right? I mean, Mara took me now. So now I can do, oh, you're very lucky. It's only a 13.
You're only slightly charged.
It's like a point of damage, right? Isn't it?
Yeah. Is that going to die 3?
Yeah, it's very little. It's a 1d3. Yeah, 1d3. Mm-hmm. It's 2 points of damage on the one on Ka'a.
Oh, right. So that damage was so precise. Here's what I'm going to say. The thing catches up and burns up. And Ka'a, if you can give me a luck check, you will escape unscathed. However, if not, you are going to lose an eyebrow.
I can have pretty fingers again, but this time from just being burned.
I actually succeeded.
Yeah. So you managed to, like, you know, as it catches up on fire, you managed to, like, sort of burst out from under this thing. Speckles of it going everywhere, burning pieces and things. And, you do not lose a hair on your head. It's gone, and there is only one left right now, and it is the one that is squaring off with Kai Hala. It is not attached to anybody this round, and that is when Lukarsh. Common van, drive a common van. What you doing?
Oh, it's the last one, and it's floating around trying to attack Kai.
Yeah, it's kind of like, you know, squaring off with Kai Hala right now.
Lukarsh, if you want, we can do the torch relay thing. You know, I have the torch as I'm, like, cradling Mara, if you want to, like, maybe smack it.
Do you think I could? Am I close enough to grab it and then throw it, or grab it?
You know
it,
what? I'll tell you what. If you want to hold action, well, I'll see you at the end of the order.
Well, how far am I away from either one?
You could run over, grab the torch, and fling it at the thing. You could do that.
Yeah, let me do that.
Go for that. Yeah.
Does it get a bonus since it's already kind of oily?
Or you could just go attack it. I mean,
the torch seems to do a little extra damage, I think. Yeah. The fire does extra damage. I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to step over to Gondbatar, grab torch, like a relay, and
motion. Range attack.
Ooh.
I'm fully 15.
I actually rolled 15. A 15.
Yeah, roll me a die 4 fire damage in this thing.
Ooh, 3.
You know what? That thing catches up beautifully and dies.
Get it?
Nice.
You know, that was a rough fight, though. I'm giving everybody 3 experience points. Y'all had to go round and round with those things.
That's so, exactly as I had it planned. I don't know what you're talking about.
Can I ask a very meta question here?
Yes.
You said that Mara could go at the end of the round. Can she spend her point of luck to heal before the combat's over?
I will allow that. That'll be perfectly fine.
Thank you. Is it my hit dice?
Your hit die, yeah. No. Okay. Oh.
Five. Thank you.
So I look at the masks on the wall and I ask everybody, which one of these should we give to Shilba?
All right.
Outstanding.
I am going to snag one of the masks off the wall, though, if I can.
Yeah, you can totally take a mask off the wall. No problem.
I'm not going to put it on, but I want to have it.
You have got one. You can write out your one mask from area 2-3.
I'm going to do the same.
One mask from area?
Same.
2-3.
And we've already established I'm wearing one of them. And I have another one in my hand if anybody wants to take one from my hand.
There's actually one left after the 2, 3, 4, 5.
I'll take one.
Left.
All right. I'll give you the one in my hand.
Yep.
Okay.
There's still one hanging on the wall, correct?
No, that's the last one. You have you gave him one in your hand? Then yeah, correct. There's one more hanging on the wall.
Does anybody want to take a second mask or?
Well, I don't think I grabbed one yet.
You did not.
These might be helpful decoys if we ever get shook down.
Yeah, I'll grab one. So, but they said they're simple wooden, though, right? They're not, these things are not like...
examining these things, okay, you realize that these are angular female faces,
carved with great skill, and you recognize this now as Kleshite ebony, giving it a deep, under the dust, giving it a deep indigo color. And then the interior of all the masks, according to the cob cat, the cat in the cob.
Cat in the cob.
In the interior of all of the masks, there's like a piece of cloth that covers the nose, like sort of like, you don't know how it may be glued in somehow on the interior, like the interior part of the mask there. There's a piece of cloth that covers the nose and mouth.
So like a gas mask.
Probably need it. Oh yeah, is that smell strong in here still?
It's not, it's very strong, yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna put that on.
Okay, put one on.
And there's another door in this room, you said?
Yes, there is another door in the room on the wall next to where all of the masks and robes were hanging. Guys, yes, I need a moment. So if everyone could just be entertaining for a moment. Tim, be entertaining.
Well, first off, I can show everybody how.
Let us see Simba.
Yeah. Long cat.
I vote anytime you have her on your arm like that, that is Bama. That is your owl. Your cat decides what it wants to do.
Yeah, this is Hugh. He's the camera hog. Shan is the shy one.
He wags his tail like a doggo.
Yeah, and he plays fetch too.
That's amazing.
Actually, that's actually how he lost one of his fangs, was from paying fetch. If you see, like, one of his fangs is broken.
Aww.
He needs a grill.
Yes.
He had a root canal for it, though, but yeah, he had an accident a few years ago.
My boy got a tooth knocked out by his sister. I just came home from work one day, and it was like a little snaggle tooth.
I think we need to start a GoFundMe for the gold cat teeth that we are going to be purchasing.
So much bling. I mean, it's so expensive, it might as well be gold.
Yeah, exactly. Right?
All right, so experience points have been dulled.
You said three, right?
Three experience points. Yeah, that was a fight, y'all. That was a knockdown dragout.
So we're all.
It was an iron down press on. More.
Before we go to the next door, I want to inspect this room for secret doors.
Sure.
Yeah, and I'll like lift up the rug and look underneath it.
Gotcha. Yeah, the rug. Other than like I said, it's so dry rotted. It's kind of, even as you lift it, you can feel the weight of it, sort of like getting ready to drag it and sort of come out of your, you know, come apart in your hands. But looking underneath the rug, you don't see anything. You can, Mara, you can give me a check, an intelligence check to look for secret doors.
12.
You do not find any secret doors.
Mm-hmm. But there was an obvious door, you said, though, right?
There's an obvious door, yeah. There sure is.
Yeah, and there's anything else that, for people to hide anything around in here?
There really, I mean, now that all the, there would have been before the robes left, but now since the robes, like, you know, came off the wall.
Do you think that, I asked the group, I'm asking the group this, do you think that those robes were magical constructs, or do you think they were actual ghosts?
Yes.
I think they were magics designed to protect this place.
Are there scraps of any of it left so we can go through the pockets? Are there pocket scraps?
I mean, there are some scraps left, but they're all ripped to shreds. And you quickly kind of like feel through them and do not find any, like, you don't find any inner or outer pockets. And you don't see, doesn't seem like there's anything inside any of these robes.
Oh, I pick up my bottle of oil, my flask of oil that didn't break.
Yeah, the unbroken flask of oil is still there and good to go. Okay. All right, that's awesome.
Oh, sorry, what's happening with the door right now?
No one's made a move for it.
Yeah, you want to go and
check it for traps?
Who's trying to check for traps?
I think I could. Last time, you know, I think I handled it pretty well.
You did. Go for it.
Also, just a quick question. With the mask on, does the smell of like the herbs go away more, or is it still just the smell?
It definitely cuts it down. Like, it definitely, you know, offers some, you know, it's filtering a little bit of those particulates.
Do we have enough masks for everyone? I guess we
there
do.
There are six masks and six CL, so there are absolutely enough masks. So are we all going to put one on?
Yeah, I'm definitely. Yeah, I think we should all put them on before we open this door.
Mara is not going to put a mask on. Is that what I'm seeing here?
You don't have
to. I don't trust the mask.
You
feels like a trap.
Kroger, because
stand back.
Yeah,
did you check it for traps?
Yeah, I can check it for traps if Mara wants to stand good hand.
You probably want to stand back then.
I'm with you, Mara. I'm not putting that mask on yet.
Okay, stand back with me, I guess.
All right.
We're a little superstitious in the land of eight cities.
No, I get it.
I am not standing back. I'm standing right by Luke Ark while he does this.
I thought I was checking. What are you checking?
I mean, I'll
I'm sorry. I'll stand right by Kai Halal while Kai Halal.
We can both check. It can't.
Yeah,
hurt.
We'll both check. Yeah. Yeah. Yep. I'm up there.
So both of y'all can make me a check. High number gets it. 10 or better. The second number gets plus one.
I got a 15.
I got a, let's see, 17 on the die, 18 total.
So 18 with plus one from Lucarc is a total of a 19. You do not find any traps. This door does not appear to be locked.
Do we hear anything from the other side?
You listen quietly. You listen to that door? Yeah, it sounds deathly quiet up there. You don't hear a thing.
Is there a crack or a draft? Can we tell if like that spice scent is coming from the other side of this door?
This door does not seem to be cracked or dented, or like it does not seem to be a crack. In fact, it looks very like a very tightly fitted door.
So the opposite.
Your enemy is not locked, it's not trapped.
Is there any? So there's no signs of like being sealed on this side.
Not on this side. No.
Okay. No. Nope. Right, I'll open it. You guys want to say?
I was just going to say, are there any footprints or anything? Because.
Oh, right.
No, it's very, very dusty here. All the prints have been caused by y'all. I will say you have moved the rug around and so much stuff around here that if there were tracks, it might be obscured. But when you first opened the door and were looking around, and when Luke Harp was just checking the rug for traps, while all that was going on, like you didn't see any marks in the dust. Now there's a bunch from y'all.
All right. I got a torch, I'll get someone to light one of my torches, and then
sure.
I'll open it up and take a peek if everyone wants to stand back.
All right, the door is stuck, and it's going to require a little bit of force to it.
So I look stupid. Okay.
Call the mingle.
No, I mean, you could go for it. I'm just saying.
What if it's a push door?
You said it's stuck. Okay. I'll put a shoulder into it if it's push or
pull. You're pulling it. So
all right. I'll pull it.
You want me to help, Deck? Or
do I need to? You know what?
Actually,
need help?
I want to go back and mention one more thing, Lucar. When you were checking the door out, one thing you did see, I was told how stuck it was. You're like, you see that there is a strip of cloth, a tarred cloth, in fact, that's stopping the gap between the door and the corridor floor, creating an actual seal. So this thing is actually, as you go to look, you notice this as you go to, before you muscle it open, you see there's a tarred piece of cloth. It looks like it's been tarred over there to create a seal.
Okay. That's,
so I was actually looking for that.
I'll put the mask on then.
I was putting the mask on.
Maybe they're just trying to keep the heat bill down.
Oh.
Or maybe they're smoking stuff in there and they don't want people to find out.
Maybe.
Okay, I look at, before I open this door, I'm going to look at Septus one more time, see if he's going to put his mask on. But I'm not going to say anything.
Before we open this door, can you remind me how does it work to spend luck to heal again?
Out of combat, you can take like a rest and a libation, and that will get you your hit die back plus your stamina modifier.
Do we want to kind of take a rest and have a libation before we go down here?
Yeah, we can take a rest.
We're sealed in on both ends, so I think we're pretty okay if we want to rest.
Let's just chill out here. We're locked
in the last another, you know, how long did we roll in the
50 hours.
50 hours, yeah.
A little more than 2 days. We're good.
It's fine.
My herbs, in the mask. Like in the cloth, kind of. So that's what I'm smelling. Like some of the herbs that I have.
So you're going to put them inside the mask?
Yeah, just to like, to cut, like, just so like that's 100% yeah. what I'm smelling, what I'm
yeah,
getting.
Like a nosegay. Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah, sure. Yeah, you can load some herbs inside of your mask. Woo! Rosemary!
Oh. I'm going to offer it to anyone else who wants it. I'm being extra cautious. I don't trust this.
No, I got a bag of bugs here. I'm good.
I heard libation. So since Ka there was talking about, I need a drink. Right?
That's So does this mean we have to have booze on us?
I think you need to. And I forgot to buy some. I was actually specifically going to ask one of the dudes back at the bar.
And rations don't help us?
Libations are...
Not unless it's like, you know, you got like...
There's actually...
I go with
gotcha. Gotcha. Okay, then actually, I don't have anything that'll help me. Never mind. Does anybody else have anything that will, or should we...
I just have water. We could have a tea party.
All right, somebody stole a bottle from the party.
Oh yeah, I don't remember who that was though.
Gon stole a bottle from the party for just in case, like just in case healing for later on.
Oh, all right. He's suspiciously quiet about this whole
thing. I did not.
Like I don't know what you're talking. What bottle? What do you mean?
I don't remember doing that.
You probably see him drinking it right now.
I actually wrote it in my notes because. Because I thought it might be good because of this exact dungeon part. So I thought, not this room specifically, but I thought at some point.
Actually, you don't actually need wine. It is health. If you have a restorative, you might get a bonus.
Okay. But we can just kind of chill out. And
just, yeah, you just bind your wounds and check yourself out.
Sure. Okay, I'll do that.
Brendan, is this a special wine of any sort that I stole?
Did you read new
from the
Neonian alcohol?
The interior. I have familiarized myself with it to some degree, but
I have the char open if you need it. But like, if it's just average wine or beer would give you a +0, but average brandy gives you a +1. That's how wine +1.
I'll tell you what. Give me a luck check, and if you make it, I'll let you pick one off there since we didn't come up with a thing.
Yeah, I made it by a good amount. I mean, if I want to pick one, I'm going to pick something really.
I mean, stole something heinous from the party. It's just like my.
We won't go crazy. We'll say it's Ilfmar strong wine, which will give you guys a +2 bonus to your hit die roll. All
right. Nice. I will say there's enough for everyone to take enough of a libation to kill a bottle. Everyone can take a one-time go on it.
I'm going to use my fleeting luck for this.
I'm only missing one hit point, so I think a rest will just do me. Like that way you can have like a backup slug.
One backup slug.
I never took any damage, but I still want to participate.
All the cool kids are doing it.
Jeff?
And we do have to spend a point of luck, correct?
You do.
Yes.
And if it's not fleeting, if I don't have any fleeting, I can spend a permanent luck, correct?
Yes, you can.
Okay.
I give him a point of fleeting luck to spend for that?
Yeah.
Oh, do you have any, Haley, or did you lose it when you rolled the one?
I thought I did, and I checked, and I
didn't. I think we all have zero. Like we had lost it all.
Because I got one.
Came out a couple.
If you're willing to share it, I wouldn't mind it.
Yeah. Wait. That's Ka'a, though, right? Does anybody else need it? Damn. All right, take it, Ka'a.
All right, nice.
Thanks, Rendo.
All
right,
bet.
I'm back up to full.
Same.
I just feel like I should make a PSA. Popcorn and monster do not go very well together. Anyone was thinking of trying the Haze diet. Don't.
Is it like a flavor or texture thing?
It's like my stomach is very angry thing.
Okay, so hear me out. Monster and sour gummy worms. So good. Yes.
Heartburn.
She's young. She was not happy about heartburn yet. Enjoy it while you can.
Yeah. Okay. Everybody good?
Yep. Yes. So we're going to pull this door open. Everyone is wearing a mask except for Septis. Is that correct?
Yeah, I'll put a mask on if everyone else is doing it.
All right, cool.
All right, yeah. Well, we are. clearly Blades Against Bandwidth cares.
But I have two masks on.
They're giving all the right after-school special moments here.
Darn it. Yes, sir.
We're doing drugs. We're drinking wine.
And everybody else is doing it, so I'm going to do it too.
Totally. You guys want to have face tattoos later?
And then we have our one anti-masker with us.
That's right.
All right, so we pull that door open. It opens. It takes some muscle, but you can do it without a die roll. So okay. Silent, dust-laden air fills the chamber beyond the door. As below, this room is blanketed by an untouched layer of ash and dust. 8 stone biers, arranged in 2 rows of 4, occupy this chamber, an apparent crypt. Atop each featureless stone block is a humanoid form wrapped in a gray shroud. A faint glitter is dimly visible through the dirty winding cloths. The air reeks of exotic spices and dusts. A door exits the chamber room on the far side of the chamber.
Is the faint glitter in their facial region?
Yeah.
It is in their neck region, actually.
I'm not gonna step in, since I opened the door. But I'm gonna stick the torch in so I could get a better look at the room and see the ceiling, and then I'll check the traps.
Sure. Doing it. You look around. Yeah, you can give me a check for traps, check.
An 8. Never mind.
Mm-hmm. All right. You don't see anything mechanical, but as you hold the torch in there, you can see that the air is so dusty you can actually see like particulates of dust in your torchlight, like filling the whole thing up. A few of them crackling as they actually catch your fire.
And it's just those 8 blocks and the shrouded
figure.
Yep,
so the 8 blocks of stone and a shrouded figure atop of them.
And I didn't see any traps. I'll step in with the torch.
Gotcha. So, yeah, so you guys walk inside there. Again, it has an intense smell. There are 8 of these figures that are there in 2 rows of 4, sitting on top of these stone things.
I don't notice a draft or anything. I'll just walk up to the first statue and get a good look at it.
All right. So this is definitely a mummified corpse, wrapped up in special kind of wrappings.
Wait, it's lying on a slab?
Yeah, so the slabs are like 2 rows of 4 slabs. Okay. Each slab has got like the figure laying on top, like they're not entombed.
Yeah.
They're sort of like laid out on top of these things. Obviously, these things have been, they're so desiccated. This could have been 100 years ago. There's just bones and wrappings left on top of them. Yeah.
So if I take the torch up closer to its face and stuff, can I get a
good look at it? You get a look and you can see that beneath all of this, there's something shiny around their necks, the neck of the one that you're looking at specifically with your torch.
I look back at you guys. I don't remember anything about a necklace or neck thing.
Do we have the poem thing again?
Yes. Yeah.
Read me the poem there.
Sure thing, my friend. The poem goes as thus. Let me turn the AC off. Beneath neither cup nor chain nor moon do I stand, but under the gaze of visage face, secret and awaiting the touch of hand. So that's how you get in. Is where our resting place is to be found, safe from thief, heretic, or sniffing hound. I think it's just telling us how to get in. I don't think there's anything else relevant beyond that.
Is the shroud something that's covering him? I'm covering this body, or
you're kind of wrapped around them of sailors being wrapped up with sailcloth.
Yeah,
safe from thief, heretic,
and sniffing hound.
No. So there were 2 character classes mentioned there. Just so we're clear, there's a thief and a cleric, which don't exist in this world, but Ka'a thinks he's one. So that leaves a fighter and a mage.
I think that was just.
I'm just throwing it out there as a possibility.
Well,
we're throwing out some guesses out here. So
I mean, I'll head in.
You're in here checking these things out. Skatch, go and give me a roll for Septis. This would be a fortitude save, please.
Put your mask on there, Septis.
16.
I could see it in your eyes.
Yeah. You know, your head feels a bit swimmy from how intense this stuff is, but right now you're okay.
Hi,
is there like a source of the smell? Or is like
it's kind of everywhere. This... It's like all of okay. The air is all dusty.
Yeah. Should I just try to poke through it? Use a dagger and like...
Well, hear me out. How shiny do these necklaces look? Do they look like they're worth a lot or...
You would have to actually like unwrap, cut through some cloth and unwrap to take a look.
How about this?
I got a torch in one hand. I'm going to tell everybody to stand back. I'm going to put the mask on with the other hand.
Oh.
And then, but before I do that, I'm going to eat a bug. And I'm going to stand at one end and do flaming hands like down a row of four and burn the mummies up.
I was worried about desecrating these things, but hell yeah. You don't care too much.
Yeah, I think that's what they mean by heretic. I don't think they mean cleric.
They specifically
tomato, tomato.
I think they mean crypt defilers.
Well, ooh. He's not getting anywhere with it.
Nope. It's not a fumble, but it's a success.
But you lost it.
I lost
it. That bug lost its life for nothing this time.
All right. Well, now that that happened, I'm thinking maybe what we should do is, I'm sorry, there's another door?
Yes, there's one more door.
Mm-hmm. One more door. Okay.
Straight across. I guess like straight across from where we came.
Yeah, there's only one. Yeah, it's only one door that you see in here.
Gotcha. Gotcha. I thought the way you were saying that there's only, I thought you were saying that there's only one more door till we get to the masks.
Oh.
Only one more door. But
you know, you don't know how many doors there are. There's one door here that hasn't been checked.
Yes. I say perhaps we should go forward and see if we can find the masks without messing with this. If we fail at finding the masks, then we can grab whatever shiny stuff we want on our way out. Or if grabbing the masks is easy and we're still feeling strong enough to deal with whatever might happen with us ripping off things from their necks. Either way, I feel like we should deal with this on our way out.
There is the only aspect of like leaving enemies, possible enemies behind us.
Hear me
but when we go through the door, we can like tap in some iron spikes maybe.
And my other friend from the desert has an idea.
Yeah, we could be smart and leave it forward behind. Or you guys could all go stand in the doorway and I could try stealing one and then see what happens. And worst case scenario, I run through the door and we close it.
The doorway leading to the next room?
To the next room, yeah.
Are you sure you don't want to take one of the mummies as hostages?
Let's not touch it.
Are they mangled?
I just don't think the hostage situation is going to get me anywhere this time. I know normally it works.
Okay.
I could also try to...
doors along this one wall.
I could try and shoot one of these things off of its neck with my trick shot.
Okay, so we just want to fuck with them?
I was going to do pickpocket and then see if I could just kind of get it off without, you know, like, I don't know.
I like Kai Halal's idea. I don't know. What do y'all think?
Right?
I like the idea because I'm putting myself at risk here.
I like the idea of a pickpocket to try to do it.
I'll do the one closest to the door if you guys all want to stand in the doorway.
Should we open the next door first?
We haven't even inspected this whole room yet. So,
true.
Kai Halal, do you want us to already have opened this door when you start this?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, so no one touch anything.
Yeah.
We inspect this room and then we inspect the next door. Yeah.
I think that's good.
All right, Brendan, we're doing room inspection and door inspection without actually touching anything at this point.
Yeah.
All right, so who's on room inspection? Let's do that first.
I'll do wall groups. I'm actually fine touching walls.
Right. You can make me an intelligence check to find secret doors. Lucar can give me a regular roll to look for traps and things within the room itself.
Yeah, I rolled less than 10.
I'll do the door.
11.
And Mara's going to check the actual door? And I'll Mara, give me that check. All right, if y'all are both going to work on the door, okay, then give me a... same thing, check for traps, and then highest roll gets it, with lowest roll gets a 10 or better is +1.
18.
Yeah, dirty 20 plus a 1 for an 18 is a total. It's a dirty 21, y'all. Which is the name of my new wall clothing line starting this opening up this spring. Dirty 21. I can't bite that up. I'm going after Forever 21. So
it's the thrift store version.
For stuff people grew out of in high school. So all right. So Ka'al, you do not find secret doors from checking around there. Lukark, you check throughout there. Check the ground around these things. You don't really see anything else in there except for those whatever and such. So however, Mara and Kai Hala, two things. Okay, one is that this door has got a great big old keyhole in the center of it. It's a solid seeming door of dark iron standing in a thick door stone frame. The face of the door is decorated with 7 masks, each depicting an angled woman's face, set in a spiral pattern. And at the center of the spiral, in lieu of the final mask, is an oval lock plate with an inset keyhole, which
Pause. I'm sorry. The masks are on the door, or they're carved into the door?
Carved into the door. It's okay, like a decoration. Yeah. Bas relief again. They're big old bas relief, here in the old temple. So everyone's got a style, right? However, you got a 21 on that trap check, and like as you're looking through, you realize that in the eyes of all of those masks, there are little like flat bits that would open up, and that looks bad to you. And after a quick inspection, you realize that this door is opened incorrectly, or for in some way, whatever, you know, whatever it triggers this trap is gonna, something is gonna flip those flaps open, and you're not gonna want to have it, whatever it is.
Do we think the key will set it off? Do we think picking the lock will set it off?
You got a 21. I will say this. You think that with a 21, I'm going to say that you're pretty sure if you put the key in and you turn it in the correct direction, it's not going to set the trap off. If you set it in the other direction, it's absolutely going to set the trap off. But you also...
Sorry. Which way is the spiral going on the door?
Hold on, spiral. The spiral is going clockwise.
Do we think that means anything, or am I just reading into things too much?
I like that thinking a lot, actually. It's the only... I was thinking we had 0 clue about that, but now I feel like we have 1 clue about that.
Yeah, spiral is more... if it was just a circle, then we'd be more concerned.
Right?
Yeah, good thinking. I think Kai Hala should get a point of luck. For even if that's not correct, it's still very clever.
Let's hold off all luck until we actually. So far, we have just an idea now. What are we actually going to do, Kai? Hala, you believe that you got something here. Are you going to try to open the key up with the lock going clockwise?
I believe in myself, but I don't want to put other people at risk. Because I shouldn't believe in myself.
Oh, you should believe in yourself and we believe in you. What if like, so I have a feeling it's like poison darts shoot out of the eyes, right? But yeah. They go in like a direction. So how about just everyone get low?
Another question. Does it look like the flaps, can we A, lift them up? And if we did B, lift them up, would it set the trap off?
You don't think opening up the flap would set the trap off.
So can we see what's going to come at it? Like if we...
Yeah, so you open it up, right? And there's just a space inside there. So you're thinking it's probably not a project. You would see a projectile if it was a projectile. So that it's not a dart or an arrow or something like that. It's probably...
A spear.
A blade.
Oh, no. It's poison. Poison gas. Poison gas,
yeah.
Or magic.
Or magic.
I really wish we had wads of gum.
Wait, we have a plug in the last room that we could use to plug up the holes.
You could go in there, rip that rug out, use that to.
Yeah. We want to spend some time doing that. Like, do we think it's worth it?
We'll cut some real quick.
You guys have got 79 more hours until y'all can leave. I think
79.
Cut a rug.
Yeah, this is a problem if we
nice cut a rug.
If
I
we
like
set it.
It
up, or if we set it off, and then we're sealed in here, like there's no running from this.
I liked the gum thinking. I don't have gum, but I have a candle. What about candle wax?
Oh,
candle wax.
I also have 12 pieces of chalk.
I have candles.
Just
Perhaps melting down some of these candles might be helpful.
Yeah,
and good idea. That would work as like a seal.
Yeah.
Better than like carpet wood.
Yeah.
And everyone knows that candle wax is basically like adamantine once it's like dried.
You can't be, really, it's, you know.
Unbreakable. An unbreakable seal.
All right. Can we triple tag team a disabled trap on this?
Yeah, absolutely. With everybody working together with the wax idea. Absolutely.
Yeah, I got four black candles.
All right, go ahead and give me that disabled trap roll, everybody. Highest 10 or better is plus one. Highest number gets it. So make a roll. Lucar, Kai Hala, Mara. I know it's not Mara. I know.
I got a 10, so I'm just a plus one.
Plus one.
Seven.
No modifier.
19.
Ooh.
19 with a plus one from Lucar is a 20. Yeah, you guys, you take like 5 minutes and just gum all of these things up with wax. It's, you know, it's not plutonium, but it's sealed up pretty good.
How many candles does this use?
I will say, really, you can get away with like 2 candles.
Okay, so I'll use my one candle and we'll use one of your black candles. How about that?
Oh,
cool.
And mine was kind of a beige-ish color, so I've got some beige and some black.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. That'll look very nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I like the theme we're going with here, the color scheme. Yeah. I like
it. Mix it to and marbleize it. It's like
FIFA. Need an accent wall in this room, though.
Yeah, that's. You mean the mask door with the spiral isn't the accent?
Yeah, that's pretty accented.
All right, your decorators of Lankhmar are coming soon.
I'm plugged up. I'm feeling pretty confident in turning it with the spiral.
Clockwise. So yeah. We're gonna go for it?
Yeah, if you guys are cool with it, if no one's gonna stop me, I'm trusting my gut.
Kai Hala does it. I'm gonna say my three thieves are getting a point of fleet and luck each for jamming this thing up.
Nice.
Yeah, you guys open that thing up and the door opens up without any kind of issue. Well done, y'all. Very well done.
Does the candle wax idea also warrant a fleeting luck?
You know what? Yeah, take a point of luck for old Ka there. I'll give it. You know what? I'm going to give one to Gambitar too and set this. Y'all, everyone's getting a point of fleet and luck.
We're all in this thing. Shockingly well handled for us.
You know what? Like, I feel like
you're like Gambitar, Oprah, just handing out luck.
Yeah, you get a fleeting book of luck.
You get luck. You get
miracles. You know?
I feel like I'm bringing a positive influence to this group today.
Is that the only time you've ever said that in your life?
Yeah. Terrible, y'all. It's terrible. That's awesome, though. All right. So, we have done this. You turn the key clockwise, and sure enough, you guys, there's a cocoon. We open the door up. The chamber beyond the stout door is low-ceilinged and gloomy. The dust that fills the interior rooms of the spire appears less heavy here, as if errant breezes have stirred it during the temple's long abandonment. The shadows look more gray than black in this room, possibly rife with cobwebs. In the ashen gloom, 7 golden faces glitter.
Mog.
Okay, hear me out. I still want to steal from the last room.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
So should we all like kind of stand right by the door as Kai Halal does the pickpocket?
I think that could work, and then just don't slam it on me. Like, let me sprint through it when things go badly, you know? Like, can we have that deal made?
Sure.
I'm also going to suggest that maybe 2 of us face the room that we just came through in case those...
Like taking the masks
like doing something with the masks actually activates those creatures that were on the slabs.
Gotcha. All right, so...
So I'm going to do that. I'm going to face the other way.
So you're going to face the room with the masks?
No, I'm going to face the room with the...
With the bodies, with the mummies.
Yeah.
All right, so you're facing that room.
I'll do the same.
All right.
I'll face the mask room.
Gambitar, facing the mask room. You got it.
And then everyone else is just kind of in the mask room, and then I'll see if I can pickpocket the one closest to the door, I guess.
Gotcha. All right, 1 second.
I'm still shocked at how well that door thing went. It really shouldn't have gone that well for us.
All right, so go ahead. Everyone goes in there. Kai is actually inside that room. Kai is outside. Gambitar is watching the mask room. And then Kai is going to go for your pickpocket check to snatch that thing out of there. So go ahead.
I'm torn because this D20 has been rolling really well, and I don't want it to suddenly go cold, but it might do well again.
What dice hurt you?
Always.
They're like, man.
I'm going to trust. I'm putting my faith in this one. We'll see how it goes.
All right. Rock and roll.
Okay. It was semi-misplaced. That's a 15 for pickpocket.
Wait, here's a fleeting luck.
I'll use my fleeting luck as well.
17. All right, I will say with that, so y'all see Kai Hala like goes under there and like without actually like tearing the shroud, like you just like, ta-da! You got like with a real, it's a very, very slick move with a 17. And yeah, sure enough, you have, you like come out of there with a choker. Okay, so this is like a this is a bejeweled choker. The stones are dark purple amethysts, nearly black.
Okay, so that went well, so I kind of want to do it again.
Yeah.
Okay.
So meanwhile,
yeah, something else happened at the same time.
Yeah, something else happens at the same time. So, you know, Flash, at that exact same second, Ka'ad, you take the one mask and, like, in your hands, like, cha-choink. Yeah, which clearly is, like, the nicest of the masks. The it is the center one. It is clearly, like, you take that off the wall there, and that's when they suddenly, all of them, including the one in your hands, all start to move of their own volition, and they are going to, we're going to see what's going to happen. So let's, Kai Hala is standing in the room by one of the things. You have just got the choker off it. Cha-ching, you have a choker. Gambitar, you're watching the door. Ka'ad is inside. As soon as Kai Hala made their attempt, Ka'ad took the middle mask off of there. Now the rest of those masks are doing something. Mari is watching the room. Lukark's watching the room. And let's roll initiative because things are about to, as they say, jump off. But first, I'm rolling. Ooh, how about a six for the masks? That's terrible. Okay, so I'm going backwards this time. Ka'ah, what'd you get?
Four.
Four, even though the masks are going first. Okay.
No. I don't want to be in a room alone with these things and be acting after them. So they got a six, you said?
Yeah.
Okay, and I got a four. I'm going to spend my fleeting luck. And I'm going to spend a permanent luck so that I'm also at a six.
All right. And as we all know, I always give ties to the players. So Ka'ar is now on high six. Wait, accent wrong. All right, cool. So what do you get for Septus?
12.
12 for Septus.
Twice as good as Ka'ar. Just.
And for Kai Hala?
30-20.
320.
It was on a three and it just slowly tipped to the 19. It was very nice.
I love it. Mara, how'd you do? Dose.
Wait, I didn't mean to make a rude gesture. But yeah. I did.
Sorry to our British friends.
I got a two up yours.
What'd you call me?
that you know, in England, that gets you preempted. Pretty empty. It's like canceled, but it's very, it's perfect. So that was Mara. Lukark.
30-20 also.
Well, look at you. That ain't nothing average about this man. I don't know who goes first out of you and
I have plus one.
Kai, I also have plus one. I have a 14.
I have also a 14. So
no. I'm gonna write you down afterwards and y'all can work it out. One going before me. And Gambitar.
I didn't roll as high as the thieves, but I got an 18, which is three times as much as what.
Also, can we take a moment to look at the cats making out?
That's lovely. All right, y'all.
Unlike the actual Hugh and Shauna, they get along.
All right. So, it's on, y'all. So, Kai Hala. So you go, you see something shiny is moving and things are happening in that other chamber. Let me actually give one second here. So. All right, so so you're down there below while everybody else at the top of the stairs. So, gotcha. All right, so can we say that you have a held action because we're not sure really what's going to happen with you yet?
Sounds right. Good.
Lucroc, you hear some commotion coming from up where everybody else is,
I'm what do you down. Do? Wait, what is what?
You're still watching the room where the skeletons were. Sorry, Carl.
Okay, so I'm not gonna know what's going on up there either.
No, you could head up there for a move action and be at that up the stairs and at that door and look in if you want to.
I there's some commotion going on up there. I'll run up there to see what's going on.
All right, you run up there and you can see inside the room. You're standing next to Gambitar when you get up there for the actual move. And when you get up there, you can see the inside. Yeah, those masks are all moving of their own volition.
I'll yell down to Kai and say, hurry up. We got something going on up here.
How's the problem? My thievery went well.
My thievery. Yoink. Yeah, you didn't even mess up the wrappings. Like it was real slick. You know what I'm saying? So that's awesome. So so you have moved up there so you can still act if you want to do something. These masks are coming off the wall and sort of like moving in y'all's directions. But
I'm just gonna hang. I can't wait. Right. How close are they? Can I charge one? I'll just go run up to one of them and I'm gonna grapple. I'm gonna run and grab one of those masks.
Don't hurt him. Kind of
I'm not gonna. How am I gonna hurt a mask?
I'll let you run over there and try to grapple one. Plus two.
Kyle wants me to punch one in the face.
Bing.
I'm back down to my rolling sixes and lower again.
Oof. All right, yeah, you charge over there at one, and it's like, kind of like.
I try to grab it.
Yep, lifts out of the way, like trying to catch butterflies so that don't want to be caught. So we'll come back to that. So it is now Gambitar. Gambitar, you're actually at the door, and you now, Lucark ran past you to get in there. You see these things are in there and moving around of their own volition.
I am going to, with my mighty deed, try to use my bow to, shoot it through the eye hole of one of these masks and attempt to pin it to the wall.
All right, I want to see you do it, cousin.
I got a 3 in the deed die, and the 12 becomes a 14, so that's 17 total to hit.
Yeah, son, nice. Yeah, so I will say that you definitely hit that, and you're not trying to hurt it, you're trying to pin it there.
Yeah, I want to just try to mobilize it, yeah.
So with a 3 on the deed die, I'm going to say this is a... So since you only got a 3 on the deed die, it is pinned there currently, but it will eventually be able to wriggle out, okay? But it's going to take a little bit of time, so... That will be, but unknownst only to me, how long it will take for it to free itself from captivity. So, but beautiful shot. That was awesome. Take a point of fleet and left for that. That was awesome. So, So Gambitar goes near, fires an arrow. Woo, kitty! And catches one through the eye and pins it to the wall. And that is when Septus, still downstairs, can go. You hear a bow twang from up the stairs.
And Septus is in the room with the 8 bodies, watching over, protecting Kai Hala. And I see Kai Hala pull a really neat trick. Yeah, like a tablecloth.
Exactly.
I tried to do earlier with the thing, but this time it works.
Ta-da!
Okay, so I see that, and do any of the bodies move or do anything?
No.
Excellent. So I'm going to go to the next one. This can't get any more fun unless I do this. So the next body over, it has something gleaming around its neck. Yeah, not anymore, because I'm just going to grab it.
I have a held action, right? Can I stop this from happening?
Yeah, you can go over there and try to stop him. Like physically get in his way? Yeah, sure.
Yeah, I just like slap his hand back and be like, I'll do it. I will give the next one to you, but I will do it. Just for you not to do it.
I'll tell you what. You roll your 20, I roll my 20. I got a 15.
Oh, we both
rolled 15s.
Yeah, all I was right, we're in stalemate there.
Yeah. We'll just, I'll like, oh, okay, whatever.
I want to steal a thing. God
right,
darn it.
Right.
Will you eventually give up?
I will give up and I will.
It's really interesting.
I think we just witnessed law versus chaos in action. Like as primordial forces.
Yeah, well done.
I will get out my top at the end of the, after she, I'll kind of huff over to a corner and get out my top.
All right, so you can, you go over and get your top out. So that's awesome. And it is now Ka'a and then the masks.
The one in my hand, is it also trying to move around?
Yes.
And does it feel like it wants to be on my face or does it feel like it doesn't want to be on my face?
Oh, that's a good question. You know what? It feels like it's trying to get past you. It's trying to like move away. It's not trying to face over you. It's trying to slip past.
I'm going to just grab it and hold it under my arm and run out of this room with it like under my arm.
All right. So give me a give me a strength check and you got to beat my, hold on.
Are you sure strength?
yeah, unless you got some kind of magic armpit thing happening that you haven't told us about yet.
I would 100% believe it if he said it. If he was like, yeah, I do have a magic armpit, I'd be like, makes sense.
I have a mouth. I have a scary mouth. my 8,000 curses. All right, go ahead and give me a straight check.
Yeah, I'm currently at an 8.
Yeah, you try to, and it's you know what, it's dusty and gold, and it just slips out of your hand like it's like holding.
No, mug.
She web it. We gotta try webbing it next.
Can I roll to see if I sense the anguish in?
No, but you hear some yelling from upstairs.
Excellent.
So here is what happens. Okay, so. The pinned mask, the one with the thing through its eye, spends its round trying to unpin itself. The other five of the regular masks, they all kind of float. They sort of like start coming down the hallway. So you like they start floating like that, like a little procession. So five of the masks head down past everybody, okay? Uh-oh. Other one turns around and is looking at Ka'a, and that is when some kind of burst of very cohesive light comes out of the front of the mask and is trying to make contact. This is going for your face. The mask thing wasn't, but this is definitely trying to.
We call like that a laser. Yes.
I mean...
Cohesive light?
Was it going pew pew?
Yeah.
It's going to do a total of an 8. Does an 8 get you?
No, AC 9.
All right. So you feel this blast.
So I easily deflect it.
I mean, you get out of the way, Matrix style. No. But I'll tell you what, when it goes past your head, you have this sudden moment of where you feel this like, almost like an overwhelming burst of information. Like suddenly, imagine hearing like a statically crackly weird news, like almost like a thought you almost had then rushed past you. It's weird. But the rest of them fly down and they're going to end their round. So you two are like, hey, come on. Oh, hey, masks. As the other five masks float past you guys and are headed for the other door that you guys came in through. But this round, they'll be in the middle of the air there. They can't quite make it down to that next mask at this point.
I don't get a free whack or grab at one as it tries to fly by.
You know what? You're totally right. You get a free grab at that one guy as he flew past you. So give me a strength check. Versus my looking for a.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, man.
All right, you okay?
You just got shook and bit.
I'm just like flopping around. Yeah, like, yeah.
Come and get me, coppers.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. Yeah, two's not gonna get me.
On the mummies.
Yeah. Now, don't worry though, because you know what? Lukark has another chance next round, and we'll see if he can save face. Take it! All right, y'all. So, Mara, you're down there in the room when all of a sudden these gold masks all start flying on past you.
Yeah, I'm gonna. I had my grappling hook out and rope. And they're connected. I'm going to attempt to, like, grapple one.
Right, go ahead and give me a range. Yeah, give me a ranged attack at one of these ones.
Okay. Twelve.
Hold on. Yeah, it's gonna miss. You kind of try to clank off that. Unless you want to spend, I will say you're not super far off. If you want to spend some luck.
How much luck do you have to spend?
Well,
hard to know because you roll dice.
Yeah, I would say you know what, I'm just gonna even call it. This thing, you're gonna need a 14 to hit it, and I really should make you roll a lower die attack with a grappling hook. I probably should, but no one's
proficient. Thieves are so good with a grappling hook. We use them all the time.
I agree.
Thank you, ordinary man.
Of course you do, you bunch of. What would you know about an average guy about what a thief does?
You're just kind of bloodthirsty tonight, but like, yes, I will concede to a lower dice. I will spend. I have two fleeting luck. I will spend both of them.
All right. You only need 2 points, so two fleeting luck will definitely do it.
It says I have one on the screen.
I could just be wrong.
I'll give you one.
But just Carmen, just spend one because you have your die, and I can give you one of my two.
Okay. All
right.
That way you'd be.
I keep forgetting. Three.
Yay. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, absolutely. You clunk, 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 and roll me a die six.
Six.
Okay, so here's what happens. You have this thing kind of hooked up. It's going to have to spend a round untangling itself from the face there because you kind of like got it. But also, when you did that, like you kind of got it over the front and grabbed it up this way, it makes these two grapple hook lines like right up the front of the gold mask there. And it takes some damage from that. It makes a hell of a noise.
It'll buff out. But like, I think we have to keep the masks from getting on the mummies.
Yeah, that's what I feel like.
We can tell, are the masks flying to the mummies or past the mummies? Since we're like, since I'm standing.
You know what? It looks like the masks are going for the exit door.
Yeah. Oh. Okay. Joke's on them. It's sealed for 2 days.
I know. Let me tell you something, okay?
They don't jokes have on the, hands.
Like, since that door got sealed, the joke's on the whole rest of the dungeon, okay? So there's a lot of, I mean, I'm playing it fair. The masks, they're like, you know, come and get us, coppers! So they're just trying to, you know, make their way. They're fast, too. They're not like fly as fast as a hawk fast, but they can definitely fly quicker than any of y'all can run. So
they do have an owl. I have a beloved owl with 5 hit points.
Yeah, be careful. I'm notorious for going after familiars. I actually just killed one. Gary Con online. So
yeah, that's why I've been very what's the word I'm looking for? Judicious.
Yeah.
In my usage of my owl.
I think that's the way to do it. You know what I mean? I mean, little spying things like you've been doing is cool. You know, for outdoors, because they're, you know, it's an owl.
Oh my God.
So, I could listen
to the Spellburn she was on, and there was a question about
the badger
that was like overpowered for the group and how it died and ended up killing the wizard. And she was, you know, oh yeah, everybody dies. So
I
just remember,
everybody dies. I said the wizard dies.
Just remember, the wizard's gonna die. So leave the familiar.
Yeah, you take twice its number of hit points. It's real harsh. You know, you can survive it. Hopefully, you've got help. You know what I'm saying? So luckily, your cleric is really. Oh, that's right. All right, but neither here nor there. We are in this. Mara, you've got one hooked up, like get along, little doggy style. And it's top of the order with Kai Hala. Kai Hala, you got a bunch of masks here. Minus one, still trying to make it to the door. It is your turn. What are you going to do?
You said the special mask flew its movement and then stopped and turned.
The special one is actually still upstairs. It spent its action rather than flee. It tried to blast Ka'a in the face. You don't know this, but that's what happened. So
yeah, okay. I was just wondering if it was closer to me.
Now, all of these are sort of the rank and file masks. I mean, don't get me wrong. Each one is filigree gold, gems. They're what the what? Dust is coming off them. In the interior, Ka'a, where you are in that room, you see there's all these weird, at first you thought it was cobwebs, but they're really these weird tendrils of spirit stuff that are sort of all over the place. So the whole thing's weird.
Ectoplasm?
Could be ectoplasm.
I feel so could funky.
Legit, according to portals, ectoplasm.
How high up in air are the masks?
I'm 7 feet.
So if I wanted to use one of the slabs that a body was on as a boost, trying not to hit the body, obviously, but boost up and jump to grab one and pull it down with me.
Yeah.
Because we've got my weight coming down with it. That's a lot for it to fight.
Absolutely. Yeah. So you could try to, this is what I would ask of you. An agility check to get on top of the thing without crushing a corpse. Okay. If you fail it, you're still going to get up there, but you will crush a corpse. If you still have your mask, everyone who's wearing a mask is still wearing a mask. No one's going to take them off. So I'm assuming, all right, just making sure I got the right picture in my head here. Then, just a grapple check against one of these things. And, if you want to give me let's say you give me a strength check, a DC 13 strength check, I will say you have gone up so high, I'll give you a +1 bonus on your grapple for higher ground.
All right. I will. All right. So first is the agility check, right?
Agility check. Don't crush a guy. Yep. 13.
Crunch.
That's a 4.
Yeah. You land right on this thing's head. It smushes in. This puff, big old puff of dust comes up. Give me a willpower save. Sorry. Fortitude save at +2. Also, Septus. Sorry. Fortitude save at regular. Septus fortitude save -2.
Hypothetically, how much luck would it take not to have that happen?
What'd you get? A 6? You got a 6 on your check total?
I got a 4 on my check total.
4 on your check total. You would need 9 points of combined luck, Jeff.
You got any fleeting luck?
I don't have any fleeting luck.
All right, I'll just try.
No, you sure, Jim? I still got what you have, 1. Are we
I let somebody have it at some point.
I want to say.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
because I didn't want to do it.
Begrudging it.
Yeah.
I'm not doing a very good job of tracking. No, but then Brendan gave us another one, though. He gave us
a beer.
I gave you one.
Hey.
No, that's the roll. That's my roll.
Can we a desperate plea to our chat?
I'll hear an argument. Whoa.
Because that looked that was really cinematic. Kai Hala.
No, everybody wants to see what happens. Everybody's watching the train wreck.
Doesn't
happen. Oh yeah, she just rolled a 1.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh. That's for your strength check to get up there and do it.
That was for my port save.
Okay. So,
train wreck.
It's about to get nutty here. So go ahead and roll me a die 6.
Why was mine at a -2, Judge Brendan, if I can just ask? Is that what you told me?
You
negative?
Can absolutely ask that, yes. Okay, moving on.
I got a 15 now.
You're good to go, though.
I got a 2 on my D6.
All right. So here is what happens. even through that mask, you get a, like, you hit it just so where you get a face full of this stuff.
I did shove specifically extra herbs into my mask earlier, if that changes anything.
Yeah, you know what? You got a one, right? On your saving throw? You had a piece of when you jumped, your mask flipped up a little bit, and then a bunch of rosemary stems, they broke the seal. So, like, that's what happened. You made a pathway in there. And here's the thing. It smells delicious still, but now you also have the weird scent of their weird stuff on there. So here's the thing. You have suddenly decided that despite everything going on here, that you are going to stop what you're doing and get you a bite to eat. This is bull crap. How are they going to expect you to work all night without eating? You're starving, hungry. You've earned a meal. I will let you make this attack, like your jump attack to grab this thing, but after that, you're eating. So you can still make this with your technically mid motion. So right. Go ahead and give me that. Give me your grapple check, strength check, and you want to beat my. Give me a strength check to get that height. Strength
also, check. Do mummies qualify as jerky?
Depends on how cool they were to their service when they were alive.
So wait, but people historically ate, at least in Europe, when after they discovered mummies, they ate them as food and as medicine. They actually had to start making fake mummies. Oh, and paint. They used it, like, mummy brown is really famous paint. But yeah, so like the reason why we don't have very many mummies left is because Europeans were eating them.
Yep.
That's why we don't have mummies?
Yeah, they were also using them as fuel in trains. But
the caucasity.
People had, I know, like, y'all were eating parties. My ancestors, but whatever. So like...
I'm yellow carding.
People would have mummy unwrapping parties. So like it was a fancy party you would go to. I will send you peer-reviewed articles, sir.
I'm watching
you. You go to a fancy party and then you eat
over and over and over.
I watched a movie in the last year. No, then the whole thing started out. They were doing a mummy unwrapping party. It was a big deal. They did it all the time.
And sometimes they had teriyaki mummies, and sometimes they had peppercorn mummies.
Nummy, so spicy.
Yummy, gummy mummies.
But yeah, they were considered medicine too. Brendan is very offended by this idea. You are so offended right now. But yeah, so like that's my argument for like why mummies can be considered jerky for whatever whatever God wants to do.
I just love that for once, you know what? It's wonderful to see how from season one to season two, Blades of Bandwidth, how the shoe is on the other foot now, and now Haley's character was fixing to eat something stupid. The rest of y'all are going to have to do it. That to me, that feels like coming home. Feels like coming home. Oh, Kai, give me a strength check. DC 12 or better. Cheers.
Somebody needs to give Brendan some points of luck for that.
I got an 11, but I will burn a point of luck.
Point of luck, yeah. Yes. So then, so go ahead and, you can give me your grapple check, strength check, add +1 on your roll there.
D20.
I know, I'm trying to find my other ones. I don't like the ones I'm rolling. No, that's the bad one. Oh. That's the one that just fumbled.
That's the bad one.
Are you kidding me? It's an 11. 12 with the +1.
You know what? All you had to do is beat my straight check, so you got one. You grappled one. However, yes. So right now, you got one held. Next round, you're fixing to eat something. So maybe you're gonna like turn that thing upside down and use it like as a plate for guacamole or something like that, or who knows. So yeah, man, get ready. Yeah, bunch of mummy eating weirdos. I've been to a rap party. But Oklahoma. But a mummy unwrap party.
You know, I just feel like since they were also medicine, we should get like some sort of bonus for eating them.
That's a great idea, yeah.
Yeah, this medicine.
Brendan, is a rat party when you rewrap the mummy after you've taken out a few bites?
Leftovers, like, to keep it fresh?
I'm just about to log off. He's done.
We hope Brendan likes some cookies or something.
Oh, that's just nasty, man.
Not mommy cookies, like regular cookies. Like brown butter chocolate chip.
And Brendan,
mommy brown butter?
Yes.
I thought the idea of chocolate and bacon together sounded really gross until I tried it, and it's fantastic. So
wonder if I could make that with fake end.
All right, look, I don't care how long it's delicious. It's sitting in the cupboards, it's still cannibalism. Okay? All I'm saying. Let's just get to, here's what are we actually talking about here? People jerky. You can call it a mummy, it's still a people. So I'm the weird one, you know? All right, so, but so Kai Hala leaps off the thing, busts that thing, grabs it, and as you're coming down, you're like, man, I can kill a plate of nachos. So we'll see what's going to happen with that next. That was awesome, and it is Lukark. So Lukark, you ran out of the room up there. There is the one that Ka'a tried to grab, and one slipped past you. So there's one in the room up there with you right now, and it just, some kind of cohesive light thing came out of it, just missed Ka'a from hitting him right there in the cranium.
Like a laser?
Like a cohesive beam of light.
I'm going to go try to tackle that one, since that's the only one in this room. I ain't going to run down these stairs.
All right, give me a strength check.
Yeah, I'm going to go and try to tackle this one down. Ooh, nat 20.
Ah, you beat me. Oh, I got an 18. I was like, he's never getting this one.
Nat 20 always wins.
You like get like your fingers through the eye holes and the mouth hole from behind. Yeah.
Yeah.
You got it like the grip. So, yeah, you've got this thing and it's like.
Can I put it on?
Sure. Absolutely. But next round, this round, grapple the full round action. So,
okay. You see, I'm holding it like this, about to put it on my face. I already have a mask on. Do I need a mask up here?
You've got a mask on now. You don't know.
Double masking never hurts from what I've read.
All right, I'll wait till my turn.
I did nearly pass out at Trader Joe's one time. You can't use the plastic masks. I had a plastic one and a cloth one. And all of a sudden, I grayed out. And I had to like grab one of the apple cart. Like, whoa. So don't do that. Do cloth masks. Turns out. All right. So, yeah, man. Speaking of masks go marching one by one, is going to be Lukark has grabbed one. Gone Batar. It is your turn.
Did I get a fleeing look for nat 20?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Fleeing look. Nat 20. Take it.
Yeah.
All right. So I am going to yell to my companions because. I'm not prepared for this. Are we just like, are we destroying these things? What are we doing?
No!
Grab them!
Alright, so I'm gonna run over to the one that I pinned with the arrow.
Yeah.
And I will grab it to, like, I don't know, stick it in a sack or something. I don't know. Like, I'm gonna go grab it and hold on to it.
Alright, I will say you can get an instant grab on it because it was already pinned down by your thing. It's still trying to work its way out from under that, but it didn't do it the first round. So you have got that mask. That is this one. Grab. That is Gonbatar.
Now what?
All right. So that's awesome. And it is a Septus and then Ka'a.
I shall turn towards the door that they're trying to get out. And I will roll an 18, which is exactly what I got before.
And yeah.
So I roll for how many?
Yeah. Okay.
Roll low, please, on this die.
We got all these mummies to eat. We're fine.
Yes.
110 hours.
Wow. Oh my god.
Yeah, I see some mummy eating in your future. I absolutely, before it was whatever, but
you've
now,
got rations.
I mean, it's that or Ka'a.
You have got one honestly, I'd rather sip have of wine left for 180 hours hanging out with y'all. Have fun with that.
Water.
Like the worst wedding ever. all right, that's awesome. By the way, take a point of fleeting look, that was awesome. All right, so the door slams shut, it goes, and now all those masks are like, we'll see what happens to those masks. But now it's time for Ka'a. Ka'a, that one just tried to hit you with its, we don't know what, blast of coherent light.
They sure did. Now, hear me out. I would like to anoint my wrists with some oils.
All right.
and use magic missile not to attack the physical structure of the mask, but to instead attack its animating force. Can I use force magic to just attack its animating force?
Yes, but it's going to be tricky, okay? It's going to be tricky. Like, this isn't going to be straight off the cuff magic. You're going to have to actually, like literally weave your enchantment to avoid the physical form of this thing, but only hit the face, or like only the animating power. Bro, I'm going to say that's going to be definitely a D16 magic missile check. But however, I'm a dangleist. If you pull it off and you take this thing out without hurting it, I'm going to give you 3 points of fleet and luck. You
can awesome.
Carry it with you to anything.
And I'm going to go ahead and ask Mog for some help here. Mog, help me get this mask for you. Okay. That is, let's see, the patron die was successful. So that's going to add an additional +3 to this. So that is a 15, 16, 17, 17 on my magic missile. So a 17 is going to give me a single missile that does a D4. Oh, that's lame. No, we're bumping that.
We're absolutely.
Well, hold on, Jeff. Do you know the fact that your patron die? Do you know what your bonus is?
Yeah, I rolled a 12. Okay. My patron die gave me a +3, which bumped it up to 15, and okay. I get a +2 on that, which brings me up to a 17, and a 17 is lame. So
I can give you one.
Yeah, one would be amazing.
I'll give it to you.
Okay, perfect. So I'm now doing 1d4 missiles. I'm doing two missiles, and they each do D4 plus caster level. And I rolled ones on both of those.
So
one, two, three, 4 points total.
Oh, that's terrible. All right, but still, I mean, look, however, I'm going to give you a point of fleet and luck for even going for it. The thing is still going on, but when you weave your web at this thing, like, yum, and, like, do it in just such a way, and, like, y'all see, it's almost as if, like, and the only one we really can see is Lucark, but, like, it's almost as if Ka'a has, like, fired these missiles and, like, into the body of this thing that would be wearing the mask that isn't actually there. Like, this kind of, like, burst in the air, and for a moment, you see the form of this ghostly thing, like, rocking back from the impact of those magic missiles. That was a brilliant move. Didn't kill it.
Is this the one I was holding?
Yeah. Yeah, you see all of this. Like, and just for a moment, it's like you're sharing a physical space with this ghostly presence that's between you and the mask, like between your arms, like, whoa!
Just for a moment, he gets it within. We're locked in here with him for another 110 hours.
Cancel that spell.
Or until Mog comes to collect.
Yeah.
Yeah, cancel it. I mean, here's the DCC doesn't have coherent rules for just dispelling spells, so I have my own personal rule for it that we can totally work. Tell you, we'll get to that. That'll be.
I mean, I would say maybe he can cast it in reverse. You know,
cast it, and if you cast a spell, but my rule is if you can reroll it and hit your number or better, then you can undo the effects of a spell. Obviously, not like a burn damage from a flaming hand, but yeah. For an ongoing spell effect, yeah.
Well, I mean, the spells in reverse rule, I guess, kind of works, right? With the D16.
Yeah, that's the way I would do it.
Awesome, manos.
With the D16. Wow.
No, I give you a full die for it, but just it's like trying to scrub the spell out. Like, it's an ongoing thing, so it's hard. Spells have a life of their own after you cast them. But
I like how after you said that, Jim was like, it's true. They really do have a life of their own.
Spells these days.
Well, it is their turn.
Am I right, so, ladies? Am I right?
So Lucark, the one that you have grabbed, I don't know who I'm more mad at. All I know is I can't be getting magic missile by Ka'a there. So here comes a blast of once again tries to zap you with a blast of power. And once again, rolls garbage. Another blast of force goes past Ka'a and doesn't do it. Gonbatar, the one in front of you, tries the same thing, but you've got him held and he's got a thing through his eye, so I'm going to actually make him take a roll. Do you want to die 14?
Yeah.
Nope, not today, Chester. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there are 5 that are downstairs in the room with Kai Hala and Mara and... Septus. So that's easily done. 1, 2. All right. So two of them are firing blasts at Mara. So here comes an attack roll. That's going to be a 13 and a 6.
The 13 hits.
Okay, so you take 4 points of damage, and it's like psychic damage. You feel this terrible pain like resounding through your head. I got two of them are going to do the same thing, going at Receptus. Here goes a 7 and an 8. That's crap. And then one's going after Kai Halam.
What I'm holding.
Here we go. Dirty 20 for 2 points of damage.
How rude.
And keep this damage separate. Keep track of how much we'll call the mask lasers, for lack of a better thing. Let's keep an eye on how much mask laser damage gets
the
done.
One that attacked me, the one I had grappled.
Oh, you had that one grappled. You know what? Let me re-roll that. Take that back. He is going to get a D14 for grapple laser. He will actually get an 8 with that and miss. So we'll hold off on that. So hold off on that damage. So and that is where we are when Mara goes.
So I still have the one mask.
You have that one grappled, yeah. It just turned around at you and like just try to blast you from the air.
I was going to shove it in my backpack, but I think the lasers can go through that.
Only one way to find out.
That's true.
Take the word right out of my mouth.
Okay, yeah. I'll shove it into my backpack. I guess all that's right,
give me a strength check to manhandle this thing into your backpack. I'm going to roll it like a grapple because it does not want to be shoved into your backpack. So, woof, give me a check.
Wait. 18.
All right. 18. Yeah, you stuff this thing into your backpack and seal it up inside there.
Just start hitting it on things. Like, just...
That's...
Yes. Just throw it down the stairs.
Yeah, exactly. Just throw it down.
That's some good Army of Darkness action right there. all right. You have got one in a bag. That is this one, which already took some damage.
You've got this one in the bag.
Oh, scarf kitty.
So that was awesome, and it is Kai Hala. So you've got this one grappled. However, you are about to eat something.
That's true. Now, I vaguely remember that Ka'a has rations. So I'm going to, like a bowling ball, you know, like grab it kind of with one hand and like drag it with me towards Ka'a, and I'm just beelining it for Ka'a pulling
with me. All right, give me a
bowling ball style.
Yeah. Give me a strength check, add 2 to what you get. To, looking for a 9.
All right, so I'm gonna burn. I got a 6, so I'm gonna burn 2 points of luck because I get 5 for it.
Wait, do you need fleeting?
I would love fleeting if you have it. I get a die, so I can burn.
Okay, I have 1 fleeting.
Okay.
Burn 1 for one of your dice, and if it doesn't make it, then take a point of luck from.
Okay, I made it.
Okay.
All right, cool.
Thank you.
All right, yeah, so you get there and you step into the room where Ka'a and Lukark are fighting against this thing, and Gambatar has got one gummed up on the wall, is trying to like deal with that as well.
Can I be yelling this whole time, like, yo, who's got snacks?
I want some French toast.
All right, that's awesome, and it's time for Lukark. Lukark, while you are struggling with this thing again, you just saw something. You're not sure what you saw, but you saw something. But also, you saw Kai Halaz coming in now, trying to eat.
Yeah, I tell Kai Halaz that Septus has the snacks. They're back downstairs. But I try to. I'm going to jockey this thing so it's not aiming straight at Ka'a. I feel like I'm going to. Does it feel like it's alive? I'm going to
It's resistant, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, you know, I'm going to try the original plan. I'm going to put it on my face. I'm just going to pull it onto my face. Since I have it from the back anyway, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, you pull it on over your face. So we've got it. We'll see what happens.
Do I have to do anything? Do I have to roll anything?
Nope. It seems okay with it.
It seems okay with me, right?
Yeah, right, like cool. It's not resistant. It's just going to be all right with it.
I think you're going to get really cool powers like Jim Carrey and the mask. Like you're going to have some sweet dance moves.
Yeah.
Yep. Get ready.
Do I look outrageous? Do I look outrageous already?
Woken.
Somebody stop that. All right.
I'll bet you Haley's not seen that movie.
What movies I've seen.
Trochio. Oh.
Oh my God! It's Bobby Lou.
Those little love eyes.
Hi, Bobby Lou. Come here, sweetie.
Is Bobby here?
Bobby just Bobby spent the weekend at Grammy Noodle's house and has just got back. Come here.
Did Bobby gain 10 pounds?
Oh my God!
Came back all chonkered.
Oh, she is a chonker.
Oh,
she's my
chunker.
Say hi, Bobby.
Oh, babies.
Oh, Bobby.
Oh, look at her.
Hi, little lady.
I know. She's a good girl. She probably, my mother-in-law cooks for her. Like, she got an egg for breakfast guaranteed. Probably steak at some point.
I'm doing my imitation of your dog now.
You gotta give the teeth like because she has that overbite. All right, kids. Poor Bobby. All right, kids. So we got 9 minutes left. So let's figure out how
to finish him.
Brendan, I think we can just hand wave the next 9 minutes and just say we finished it up. We totally have the masks. We're good to go.
Yeah. We're also 1,000 super gold pieces.
I mean, super rich and good looking.
We could definitely hand wave it, but that's not the way it would go. It would. I got a feeling that it would wave out like. So the masks win, they go back, they hang out
on the wall. Our faces are also on the wall.
To eat all of us.
Everyone gets eaten. The mummies eat y'all, see how we like it.
So, that's not fair.
Jokes on them, I taste horrible. I haven't showered in weeks.
By the way, it's interesting to me, Brendan, that you said, see how we like it. So you're definitely identifying
mummies. I'm the dude. I am a player advocate. Anybody knows me knows that I am on the side of the players because what I want is a good story. It's all I care about. You know what I mean? I'm not a killer GM or whatever. I just want to have good fun times we can laugh about later on. So let's see if we can't crank out one more. Let's get to the bottom of the order. See if we can't pull it off. So that's Gambitar. You're up next.
All right. Since I have a mask and I'm willing to make this be my cut, because I don't know what else to do. And this thing's shooting lasers at me. I'm gonna take out my dagger and I'm just gonna like slam it right through the center of this mask.
All right, I'm gonna see you do it. You can actually roll a d24. It's pinned.
It never works out in my benefit.
Oh.
It's always like, oh, you have a higher die, and then that's like 2.
Yeah. Like that when I rolled a 7.
Well, you still got your D die. What's your total with everything?
With everything, luckily, I got a total of +5, so it's 12.
Yeah, 12 is kind of close. You want to spend 2 points of luck?
You can have one of my fleetings, Gambitar.
Oh, yeah, you can have my other fleeting.
Look at that, man.
So you got it.
It's like everybody helping each other out like X-Crawl.
So then I get +2.
All right, roll me damage.
Where the heck's my d4? Here.
2, 4, and the D die was a 3, so that's 7.
Yeah, man. So, that is Batar. Oh, that's this one, sorry. Yeah, it is still up, but, you've definitely, like, injured it. You've put that knife almost clear through it. And, it is, keep going. So, it is Septus. You got 5 masks in the room with you right now that are trying to destroy. Well, 4. One's in a backpack. Now, well, 3. One went upstairs with the snack train. There are 3 masks left. It's up to you.
How can you be fighting me on that? It must be supporting the snack choice.
Oh, you know, Who knows what these masks are about? It just wants to be let go. That's all. So, yeah. So,
all right. I'm going to burn. I'm going to spell burn.
Burn stuff just to the ground for the next person.
Why wouldn't I?
Who is?
I have to pick the guest next week. Like, please, please take this character. I know.
I'm going to burn 6 points. Two from strength, 2 from agility, 2 from stamina.
Well, like, we'll get them a fruit basket or something. It'll be fine.
I mean, if you're going to do 6, you might as well do 20.
I'm going to make you guess next week. You have to deal with this.
I would happily do it. I'm going to cast rope work.
All right.
All right. So that's 23. Cast some drops above. He's just he can command rope guys in the other. And rope is one of those.
One of my bid.
I feel like he just cast the spell right there. Whatever that mumbling.
Exactly. Yes.
What does it do?
Okay, so rope work is one of those that you can do anything
at work.
So I got a 23. I'm actually going to look at the 18 to 19.
Okay, so it's a tangle attack.
Yeah.
All right, here comes that agility save versus the save will still be a 23.
I appreciate it.
Oh, can't do it. Yeah, you have entangled a mask up there. One mask is entangled. Downstairs.
Will that just like slow it down, or because like it's still moving? It's like it was walking. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I will say, the rope. I don't know. That's a good call.
It says, a constrained target cannot move or take any action other than to talk.
Power of the core, what compels you?
Now, the question I have is, does it just wrap around the mask, or does it wrap around some incorporeal form that is the mask?
Just the mask.
Okay, thank you.
Gotcha. All right, so yeah, that is awesome. And it is, we are going to keep going. It is Ka'a.
All right, well, Mog, aid me again. I'm going to do the same thing, but I'm doing it on the mask that Lucark is wearing. Gotcha. So we'll see what happens now. Okay, so my D16, okay, that's only an 8, but let's see what my patron die is. My patron die, that's a success. So that's a 4, which adds a plus 4, so that 8 is now a 12. And I get a plus 2, that makes it a 14. It takes 1 point of damage.
Guess what? You just, that one goes down.
All right.
Oh, wait. Nope. Wrong one. Sorry. I got confused. What do you got? You want to spend some luck on your magic missile? 1 point of damage. Not great. Maybe you can do it.
Yes. Do I have a sense as to how much luck I want to spend? Because I'm real low.
We're talking about a spell chart here. So there's so many variables here. I hate even saying. Just how high can you get it? But is there anyone got any fleet luck for Ka'a?
You get my spell result up. I thought you meant spending luck on a point of damage.
No, on the spell result. If you want to.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I would need two more points.
I'm all out.
Same.
Crowd. Anybody still watching? Can throw a couple points.
Nope.
No one's
Sky too has some luck.
You know what? I'm going to spend 2 points of permanent luck.
All right.
Which takes me down to luck of 4. Oof. And okay, so now instead of the 1 point, it's going to be a D4 plus caster level.
Okay, let's do it.
Hey, luckily, like all this luck spinner has set us up for some more carousing.
4.
Yeah. So Ka'a blasts this thing, and like suddenly, Lucark, you are wearing an inert mask. Doesn't feel like anything to it and such. Well done. Take 3 points of fleet and luck, as I said.
Thank you.
So this is Ka'a, it is their turn. How about we, it's time, so how about we stop here? We'll pick up with the mask turn next time.
Sounds good.
Cool. So, okay. Let's do a roll call here. Don Batar.
Yo.
You knifed a mask.
Yes.
You were upstairs. All right, Lukark and Ka'a are both upstairs. Dead mask.
And I'm wearing it.
Yep, dead mask.
And I'm telling Lukark that it's time to give this mask over to Mog.
All right, Mara is downstairs. You have one in a bag.
Mm-hmm. Brendan, do you want me to stop the stream so the TSR guys can jump on?
Yeah. Thank you all for tuning in. We'll see you guys next time on Blades Against Bad Rift.
Stay tuned for Chris Doyle.